Yeah, it's flipped. Swap. It's flipped, yep. All right, let's go.
All right, so already pressure with Suzerain and just, you know, neutral's happening.
All right, Mimi bursts out. All right. A lot of neutral Suzerain from Orion Ken. But that's actually quite normal because, like, obviously he wants to check out Stun Inch with Suzerain. Corner pressure? All right. All right. Yeah, there we go.
Yeah. So, yeah, there we go. The Azami waits for the stab. So that's good awareness. He's going to need to keep that up. All right. Suzerain to throw. All right. Yozansen, instant overhead?
Instant overheads, yeah.
All right. Will he be able to take him down for the knockdown? Oh.
Okay.
Yeah.
Lofo try to go for a throw, maybe?
Yeah.
A little too ambitious. Not even a run throw, just walk up. But Ryan Kent does not allow the approach.
Oh!
Tried to scissor him, but didn't catch the close seed.
Yeah, I think he canceled into the follow-up a bit early, and that's why I got counter hit.
Mm-hmm. Oh, nice!
Yeah, good conversion. Here we go. ID to Tommy.
Already in the corner. Gets out.
Nice. Yeah. Just barely misses the air throw there.
Switch of spice. Okay.
Ooh. Oh, nice! Suzerain into low Azami?
Yeah, he
tricky
knows.
Stuff.
It's already a rock, paper, scissors situation from there anyway.
Yeah.
Interesting, goes into super.
Yeah, that's the most damage you can get off a 2-slash confirm, I believe.
Yeah, and then gets a knockdown too. Bit of a corner carry too, surprisingly. Suzerain run again. Okay. Alright, how many
there
loops?
We go. Yeah, he's just gonna go for...
Yep, four loops.
Yeah.
Doesn't get hard knockdown from four loops.
You'll see that Ryan Ken, he visually confirms that he's not going to get the hard knockdown. Instead, just sets up the tech situation. So that's good awareness from him. And maybe Yozansen? No.
Gold burst. Ooh, I got this gold burst.
Okay, I don't think that was a punish. I think Ryan Ken was swinging.
Yeah.
I'm not quite sure, though.
Ooh,
nice.
Yeah.
Tried to catch that back, perhaps.
Yeah. Oh, the online unblockables.
Ever.
All right, maybe Lofo got this. Who knows?
And he gets chipped out.
Yeah. The Scorpion, come over here, chain move.
Yeah.
I forgot the name.
Yeah, that's actually the move. Everyone just calls it chain. So.
Yeah, chains.
HS chain.
All right, so Lofo had a good idea. Yeah, he almost had it back, but maybe a little too late on that. A little low on health and everything, so... Get that swig of water. Obviously, he's just trying to everything, thinking about everything from that match to the earlier match, and
I think so. Lofo.
Yep.
He's not. It's not that he's necessarily playing behind Ryan Ken, but it's just Ryan Ken's getting started a lot earlier,
right.
And then Lofo has to work a lot harder from behind. So, all right.
There's a thumbs up from Lofo, just like Street Fighter V Esports. Here comes second match. Here we go.
All right.
Okay.
Nice. A little bit of awareness from the Suzerain to the neutral.
Back dash to the 2S, Oki.
Tries to throw him there. Oh, that was really funny. So he waited for the Azami and just actually hit the follow-up, counter-hit low.
A little ambitious with that DP right there.
I think that's also what Ryan can want to do, throw him in that situation, but doesn't work out. Nice. And now we see... Oh,
that's
yeah,
catch.
That's, yeah.
Oh, trades.
Okay, you know what?
Interesting.
That move is a mystery to us. Seems.
It's like sometimes perfectly reversal, sometimes trades. Well,
right.
6H recovered in time. That new 6H. I heard the nerf, quote unquote, the recovery of it, but still worked pretty well.
Yeah.
All right. Get that gun. Ah, nice. It's on me a lot. Yeah.
But Lofo choosing to back off, which I respect. Doesn't really want to get into a scramble situation.
Mm-hmm.
Rather just hold on to his lead.
Yep.
It's good that he's counter hitting the follow ups. Either way, like he's gatling into either a low or a high.
Yep. Runs in with the 2K, but doesn't convert. Now he gets stuck. Knocked out.
I like that air dash mix-up from Ryan Ken. That was actually nice. All right.
No tatami.
Slams, gets him in that pressure.
Yep. Oh, misses the jump S.
All right. Lofo with an opportunity here.
All right. Get the pressure going. Sets up another one. Interesting. PRCs.
All right, puts himself in the corner. Nice.
Ooh. RC stun edge.
Right.
Oh.
So, I like how Lofo is definitely trying to play around this stuff now.
Oh. Tries to go for the air throw.
Oh no.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, it's good for him to try and contest this round, I believe.
Air throw.
Nice. double jumps out of there just barely, and Lofo. I like his conservative approach to offense. He's not overcommitting. He knows that, and also in the neutral as well, he's waiting for the Suzeran to come out. He's waiting for the Azami, and then even if he sees him holding Azami, he'll still threaten him by trying to maybe hit the startup of his follow-ups and whatnot. So
the follow-ups are really fast though, so you gotta be very careful with you.
Yeah, definitely.
Because sometimes I try to like. Try to go in with a jump cancelable normal, right? Which is most, and then try to chicken block the follow up.
And it still gets you a jump start.
Yeah. And I'm like, oh, okay. It's pretty brutal.
Lofo. Definitely something to be wary of.
Yeah. All right, one piece of each. Going to the final match here.
All right.
RS. Okay.
All right, nice.
Ryan Kent with their approach.
Oh! Sorry, Lofo attempted to throw there, and Ryan Kent double jump.
So. Oh, heck, jump S. He throws again, yep. Yeah,
Oh, nice!
Questionable burst there from Lofo.
Definitely, but also good awareness from Ryan Kent.
Is this gonna be enough?
He did double jump confirm. I like that, because I'm pretty sure he would have had a hard time knocking down in that situation.
Right.
Which is why. That or he just wanted the extra damage, but either way, Ryan can.
Yeah, it worked out for him.
Alright. Bit late on the 6P there, but.
So hard to
anti-air heavy stun edge.
Yeah. Kai usually as a character is really good with anti-airs, and then he definitely. Ooh! 6K to avoid that. But yeah, sometimes he wants to anti-air Viking, but it's so scary because he has those tatami pressures as well, which will neutralize the 6Bs and such. Gotta respect those.
Nice.
Stun inch, all right.
Could use stun inch to cover the horizontal distance on the ground.
Not bad damage on that Yohazunsen combo. Gets tagged. There it is.
Nice. Instant overheads.
This might be it.
Yeah.
There it is.
Good stuff from Ryan Ken.
All right. That was still winner's side, though.
Still winner's side, so we'll definitely see more of Lofo.
Yep.
And, as well as Ryan Ken. Woo! Yep. So, Yohazunsen definitely clutched up for Ryan Ken there. He got good mileage out of it both times he decided to use it.
Oh, yeah.
There was only one time where he did it without meter, and in that situation, Lofo was still able to scrap him afterwards. But other than that, still good. All right. So, coming up next, we have Teapots versus Psychotic, which I think is actually a very good match.
Yeah. Teapots come here from going through quite a gauntlet himself as well, and
also he's just been an up and coming player over the past like year and a half or so.
Oh yeah,
2 years.
Sure.
Definitely since the beginning of Sign. Used to play Kai, switched to Coom. I know he tried a bit of Milia, but definitely going Coom here.
Yeah, I remember Toryuken last year. He was like switching between like Kai, Axel, like something like that. And then Revelator came out, and the Coom DLC came out. And then since then, he's been putting in the lab works, man. Like,
oh yeah, for sure.
So it really shows. And of course, Psychotic. If you guys are familiar with the Toronto, any of the Toronto tournaments, you've probably seen him once or twice. You know?
Yeah, definitely. And honestly, Psychotic's been to plenty of U.S. majors. I'm sure if you've been to a major event in the last 2 or 3 years, you've definitely at least seen him.
Yeah, in both Guilty Gear and especially in Blaze Blue.
Especially in Blaze Blue.
He won Blaze Blue yesterday. So, and today, obviously, he's still ripping in Guilty Gear, winner side top 8. So, Coom versus Sim, both quite the high damage character.
Yeah, I think Coom's going to be the one working in the neutral here.
Yeah.
All right, they shake hands.
Yep. All right. All right. So we got those
transformation
scenes.
Tuner.
All right. Both got the green color going. It's a little different color from what you Sakai usually use, but it's okay. First offense from
All right, instant blocking those is going to be important.
All right. Gets cornered, but, oh, interesting. So Sakata backs off.
Yeah, I think he was wary of the way that T-Pots was just kind of waiting there.
Yeah. Yeah, and T-Pot is not scared to like let it rip with those 6H. So definitely something to care for about.
All right, here comes the situation.
Blocks the low.
Nice blocks from Psychotic.
Hayabusa, 2 PP.
Nice.
Oh, there it is. Ground bounces too.
A little bit of air flutes with air Hayabusa there.
Try to go for a throw, maybe?
All right. Oh, man, this Hayabusa pressure.
Yeah, this is all Gokum right now.
Oh,
ooh,
yeah, it ends up being safe anyways.
Yep. Lots of Grand Vipers.
Oh, hits him. Slides under the ball and makes it disappear. Ooh, good situation for Psychotic right now. He has to eat. Still needs a good, like, one or two
all
hits.
Right.
That was so funny. Him. The camera panning, actually, I was unsure of what was happening. He was already sliding by the time it came out.
That move is super good because you can start controlling before Super Flash ends.
Yeah.
Yeah. So if you expect that, you're going to try to slide under the regular fireball. Just
already
down.
There.
Yep.
All right.
Lots of instant blocks here. That was this. No confirmed.
Nice. Just jumping around. Oh, tricks him out and then goes for the dust.
Yep. Kung Dust is just really good in general. Good range. One of the few dusts in the game that's actually positive on block.
It's plus one, I believe. Yeah. So. Honestly, even if they block it, it's still a pretty good look.
Yeah.
All right. Oh, fade back Hayabusa. He got counter hit. I can't help but think he maybe was trying to throw him or air to air, but this is all T-Pots right now. Crosses him up. Unable to convert, but.
Nice use of YRC there to make his approach really unpredictable.
Ooh, good slide. Gets a little bit of a Hail Mary. Had meter to back it up, though.
A little bit of damage here. Kun can take those, though. The overhead.
Oh. All right, he's trying to just
jumping
get the hit
it.
In. A lot of jump back Hayabusa.
Sakai definitely wants that air throw, but dang, backs off now. Super,
oh, and
all
that's
right.
Going to be his turn.
Ooh. Yeah, he really wanted that food. He wanted his food to be, like, safe. Ooh!
Oh my, that's unfortunate. Psychotic.
That
the composure to hang in there. Just play it nice and slow.
Little too overambitious with those air Hayabusa kicks.
Definitely. And just as you say that, just go for it anyway.
It's still a good move.
Oh, here we go.
Real good damage. A little too far.
Still, though. Forced to respect the ball.
Yeah.
And now, a little bit of a scramble situation.
Same with the slow wake-up speed.
Oh. All right, that was definitely a weird little scrap.
Bit of damage here.
Man.
This time he gets punished.
Yeah.
Overhead.
2P into jump dust.
All right. Still anyone's game.
All right, yeah.
Just jumping on too much. Oh.
Will he? Yeah, I think he should be able to end this. Yeah. Oh, you know what? It looked to me like he actually tried to bait that.
Yeah. RTL?
Oh.
Yeah. Okay.
Nice.
I was a little scared about if he could punish, but a good choice there with the Hayabusa.
Definitely. But honestly, Psychotic was pretty close to losing that convincingly. The fact that he was able to bring it back is, you know, able to maintain some of his momentum going into the second match here.
Oh, yeah. Sorry, off for 6P. Oh, there it is.
Big counter hit, yeah.
At first, doesn't want any of that. There, right. Elk to go under the fireball. Yeah.
Nice. Just stares him down.
Just wait. It's all good.
Uh-oh.
All right.
Yeah.
Let's calm down a little.
Nice. Just charges it down back by the fireball.
Okay.
All right. Low on food is Psychotic, so he's got to
chase
base.
Down that pack dash. All right.
Oh. All right. He's got to eat now.
Yeah. Usually, Kum will have to respect those, like, let him eat it, but...
Oh.
But he's okay with that.
All right.
Fireball.
Nice. A little bit of a cross up there.
Yep.
Oh, input error. Perhaps he wanted super? I don't think he wanted that on wake up.
There's a 2P mash.
Ooh.
Good use of FD right there. All right, here comes the big ball.
And now it's Kum's turn.
Yeah, the Kum ball.
Ooh. Right. Yeah.
That was actually really smart just at the end, too, because that fireball, even if Kum gets hit, it stays.
Ooh. Oh, man.
Nice.
Nice. Oh, okay. A little bit of a weight on there.
He didn't have a blitz back, so I would have not charged that, probably.
Yeah. Maybe he was a bit wary of sending him full screen. Ow.
Oh! It still works out, but sending him a message.
Nice conversion.
Nice.
All right. Yeah.
There's a high. All right.
T-Pot's in firm control of the match right now. Psychotic with no meter. All right, let's burst out right away.
Alexander knows. Ooh, interesting. TK peak driver.
All right. Chases him down in the air. Doesn't want to give him the space for the Hayabusa.
Gets the food. Giving them clap.
Oh, clap.
Woohoo. Yeah. Tied to the beating.
Nice. Good spacing from T-Pots.
It's plus. Good blocks.
Oh, that was so weird.
Oh, nice. That was Hayabusa. Oh, wow. Did that beat 6P? I swear he got 6P out. Whoa, geez.
That looked really weird. Okay. Now. Yeah, just backs up. Doesn't really want to overcommit.
Oh!
All right, Psychotic being a little bit more wary of their Hayabusa this time around.
Yeah.
Oh, Elk.
Since 6P is still a problem, so. Gets right. poked.
Oh, unfortunate. But still gets a good amount of damage.
It is Sin, after all. All right.
Here we go. Nice. Maybe try to catch the up back with a 6P there.
Nice DP. He was definitely going for a run-up throw right there. Oh. All right.
Oh, up back HS. A
little bit of stare down right there. Corner pressure. Right, ooh, yeah, no, I got this burst. Well, he has to burst, I suppose. Poke, poke.
All right.
Oh, nice. The Grand Viper.
The Grand Viper.
Oh.
Oh, that was weird. Oh. All right. This is still very scary for Psychotic.
Yeah, dead angle's out. Mirror for Psychotic. Yep, that is how it works.
All right, that camera pan is doing some funny stuff this time around.
T-Bot's like, yeah.
All right, a little bit less pressure because both these guys are winners, but of course, they both want to advance, ideally.
Ideally, yeah.
All right. Oh, that's going to be a whip punish. And a very good whip punish at that.
Yeah, he doesn't bother for loops. Doesn't matter. Still damage.
Yeah, I was on the lookout for that air high boost there, but it's smart for him to YRC it.
Ooh, okay.
Just barely.
Yeah, you have to be really careful about Sin's wake up beast. One of the slowest in the game by far. Oh, let it through. How much can he get off this? Pretty chunky damage.
Interesting air ender. I respect it.
Yeah, it's still a hard knockdown. Burst out. Nice air throw.
Ooh.
There it is. Wait. How many loops?
Yeah, should get him here.
Yeah. Good damage. Wow.
And this is a match point for T-Pots here, so it's like, I'm going to have to play a little bit more conservative. Or who knows, maybe he should rush it down, but either way.
There is a six. Yep, gets the conversion.
That's a funny conversion. Right. Knew he was going to fade back with the dust there.
Yeah.
So wakes up confidently.
Oh, here he
everybody's
comes.
Favorite. Oh, that's getting punished with mortal counter.
Oh, no.
All right. So.
This is going to hurt.
I don't think he's dead, but he's
not
bleeding.
Not dead, but.
He tried to RTL. He wanted to RTL there. That's a psychotic special to clutch it out with a well-rising HS and RTL.
Is there faint?
Yeah, look, that was a startup of his super, right?
Yeah.
Oh,
he's plus
one?
Yes.
Oh, Psychotic still with Burst. Might choose to do it on block.
Okay, a little too far there.
Burst RTL. And that's just going to take it.
All right.
Had to spend his Burst, but honestly.
He really wanted that win. Like,
yeah. No, I'm perfectly okay with that.
No Burst, though. He might. Oh! Chases him down.
Yeah, chases him down indeed. Here we go.
Nice, up on it. All right. Oh, okay. Oh no! That was a little scary there. That 6H was definitely accidental. Trying to go for a throw and accidentally got the 6H. A little risky stuff.
Elk trades. Just ends up bursting. Doesn't want to deal with that. Nice.
We'll convert it. Close to
all
the
right,
corner.
Psychotic. Yeah.
Woo-hoo.
That was a very risky bar, but he had to do something. I don't think he wanted to take that.
Oh, air air.
Oh! The dust. Still unable to convert, but. Honestly,
6P.
Counter hit. That should do it. Yep.
And there you go. T-Pots 2-1.
telling you, man, T-Bots is looking strong right now.
Strong. Like, oh, man, that Coom. Good. Like, he's converting well. He's assessing the neutral well, you know? It's like, I don't think Psychotic made mistakes or anything.
Just, no, not really.
Just that during that match, T-Bots had the upper advantage.
All right, so next we got Bram Combo versus Peppery Splash. This one can be interesting.
Yeah, Bram Combo from Windsor.
Windsor.
Apparently, though, he is the only part of Windsor community for like a year, I believe, because he's originally from like the Middle East, I've heard, when I was talking to him yesterday. Yeah, cool guy.
And very solid player as well.
Oh, yeah. He in pools, he beat Roldy.
And Poshby to make it out, I believe.
Yep.
So
he beat me as well. Yeah, he beat Roldy, then me to get into the top 16. And then
played Poshby.
Yeah.
So this one will be Raven versus Johnny.
Raven versus Johnny.
Interesting matchup, for sure. Peppery Splash, very explosive player. He likes to get into your mid-range and force you to make like decisions, because he's just going to keep pressuring you. He does play both Johnny and Zato, but...
Yeah, he used to be a Slayer player.
Yeah,
and then
you can tell he was tired of that life.
Yeah.
Went straight to the... The good old stuff.
The good old stuff. Yeah. I don't know if he would... he's not scared to go into Zato if he has to. But, I guess he's going to stick with Johnny, which is fine.
Between the two, I do like his Johnny more. They're both... he actually just put time into both of them, but...
All right.
You know.
Button checks?
Button checks.
Yeah, hype button checks. Oh, my God. All right.
But this is another matchup that I'm interested to see, as I've never seen it before.
Yeah,
so.
And also this is Revelator 2 Raven.
Revelator 2 Raven.
Got some quite beefy buffs for him.
Yeah, I honestly, in the first version of Raven, I thought it was a little bit disappointing that his excitement meter was like barely a thing.
Yeah.
And now, that's like, he's basically a resource character now.
Yeah.
Once you get that high excitement, you got big payoff.
He gets it from, obviously, command grabs now, and...
The rate at which it increases when he armors as well.
Yep.
Is buffed, so.
And then Bram Combo, at least against myself and a couple other people, his use of like excitement stance into YRC to check people was really good. So we'll see how this goes. Oh, immediately starts off with it.
All right. You see, just one move and he's already in there with the excitement.
Yep.
All right, we'll see what he goes. Good back dash. Recognized that the ball wasn't quite on top of him.
Yeah. Alright, already cornered here, but...
This is what I'm saying. Peppery Splash likes to get up in your face and play that mid-range game to make you...
Ooh. Yeah. Gotta watch out for the 2H. Like, even if Johnny goes in, you gotta be worried. Like, even if you want to throw him, that 2H will get you. If it counter hits, you're Dunzo.
And Dunzo is a very good word to describe the amount of damage that Peppery Splash will be pumping out here. He lands a clean hit.
Yeah. Fortunately... Raven is a character that has high guts, so the longer the match goes, technically it is in favor for him. Nice. Checks him out on the approach.
This time he calls out the backdash. Very good. Already making adjustments.
Oh, wow. That was a delayed hit on the dead angle right there.
You can't help but think he wanted to do the down one there, but maybe there was a... I don't know.
The Windsor guy's getting hyped for Bram Combo.
And as they should, honestly, if he wins, that's a big upset.
This is on the loser side of the bracket. Here's Combo. Yep. All right.
There
you go. Standard combo.
Low. Nice. It's in 2K.
All right. Oh, this is it.
Yeah.
All right.
So just decided to make his space. Oh, Panther.
Overcommitting too much with that block string right there. Okay. Oh, crosses under. Reads it.
Nice. Alright, scary knockdown situation as he can go for the overhead. Oh, decides to get in his face. Yeah, treasure hunt should end it if he gets the follow-up.
Yep.
Alright, boom. Let's hit him with that level 3 finder real quick.
Yep. Just end it. Still has burst for Peppery, but we'll see what the approach is here.
I really like the forward dash right at the start there.
Yeah. Get that corner pressure early in the game, which is important. Again, Johnny doesn't have a strong reversal, so especially in the corner. So you really want to take advantage of that.
Speaking of the corner.
Ooh, All right.
It's not a big deal. Just hits him with another one. And of course, he's going to take him right back down.
Okay. Yeah. There it is. Treasure hunt again. Yep. Good confirm.
Oh, all right. First
gutsy hits him burst by work.
I'll definitely say.
Nice.
All right. He needs to take this all the way.
There's a low.
And that's the start. Oh,
I like
fuzzy
the idea.
Out. Yeah. All right.
Oh.
Oh. Gets hit out of the dash.
Raven trying to find the safest approach with punish on the 6P there with YRC. Okay. Mm. Good awareness.
Yep. Hit for hit, Peppery Splash is doing a lot better in terms of his payout.
Yep.
So, Bram's going to have to get a lot more hits in, for sure. Nice. Goes for the throw bait.
Yep. Gets in. Ooh, backs off immediately.
Ooh. 2-8 just punished. Burst. That's an unfortunate burst.
Yeah.
Nice.
Yep, 2-H.
All right, Chuck Daggers. I like it.
Blitz. Where is he?
Nice, gets under him. All right, he's all over the place with his dash.
Yeah.
Oh,
doesn't get it. Convert, well, he didn't have the meter to go into Treasure Hunt anyway, but still could have got something. Might be in here. Misses it.
Misses it.
Too high there. Couldn't get the full conversion. It's not dead, but this could be bad.
He's got the... Yeah.
Oh!
I like it.
All right.
That's what he needs to get back in this. Oh, Airthrow gets out of there.
Yeah, okay. Both player knew what each other wanted.
With punish on the scratch.
Yeah. Dash, level. He had a level 3. Well,
Preppy Splash has been getting some good whiff punches in for sure. All right. Back against the wall is Bram combo. Both figuratively and literally.
Ah, 2-H.
Uh-oh.
That was even throw range. Oh,
yeah,
no.
So he just built it there, but I still would have liked for him to wait a little bit.
Cross up K, okay. Peppery Splash, just waiting. He knows that he's in an advantage. He doesn't need to get in. Just let Raven come to him. Ram Combo needs to figure out a solution right here against a full resource Johnny. Not even attempting to dead angle out that because... All right, there it is. That should end it.
Should end it, yes.
Burst super damage.
You gotta pose real quick.
And there you have it. Peppery Splash moves on, and Bram Combo takes 7.
Good stuff for him. Showing up and surprising everyone with a top 8 finish. So.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
Big ups him. And of course, congratulations for Peppery for moving on. I know Hamilton's excited about that.
Oh, yeah. All right. So we got the other side of the loser side. It will be FNM K2 versus SA. Veterans.
Veterans, of course.
One way to describe them, for sure. Veterans.
These guys threw down in teams, right?
They did.
They did.
They did.
So I'm wondering if that's going to play a factor here. I can only assume it does, but...
You know, both characters... Well, Ino versus Mei. Ino can potentially... If this was back in the AC days, it's like one bad hover dash and Mei 6P hits you, and it's you're dead.
You're done.
Revelator, you know, a little bit more fair.
Yeah,
but
kicked it back a little bit.
But still, high damage character from Mei.
He's not gonna start with jam, is he?
Please don't.
I don't want to see the jam, but it is him playing up there, so it's.
So
he's thinking about it.
For those who didn't watch the top 16, K2, he's been
playing jam a lot first game, and if he loses, he'll switch right to Mei. But it's still, I've seen him win a lot of sets that would have been a lot less stressful had he. Oh, there we go.
Yeah, okay.
He's thinking about it.
He definitely thought about it.
K2's jam is good, but it's just throughout the day I've seen him go down and have to win the set with Mei like at a disadvantage. Yeah. So. It's
maybe,
just good to hear he's starting off
maybe
with.
Maybe in like a final situation, 3 out of 5, maybe a little bit more safer to do that. But like, the thing is, like, I don't know what Jam offers that Mei doesn't, aside from speed. Like, damage Mei has them. And like, set play, obviously Mei's is better, right?
Yeah.
So like, I'm very curious to know what K2's philosophy on like the choice of Jam over Mei. So.
It could just be that he's interested in the character, of course.
Of course, yeah.
Something you have to ask him, I guess.
Yeah.
Okay, but he's not playing around. He knows SA.
Yeah, he
knows.
He knows.
All right, gets hit by the low note, but SA unable to fully convert.
So as a main player, he definitely wants to, he's going to be in the air a lot because her jump normals are crazy good.
But and then, that jump arc as well. All right, burst.
But Ino does have a lot of answers against airborne characters, so... And then, of course, gets the pressure going right here. Lots of neutrals with the projectiles, nodes, and otters. SeaWorld versus some sound festival.
Yeah. And you can see that K2 hasn't really gotten a chance to get started.
Yeah, this is raw SA right now.
All right.
Yeah.
Oh, throws him into the node as well. So I noticed that K2 is favoring the otter in the neutral. But it is still very early in set, but yeah, that's what I'm saying. I guess it's just cover more airspace.
It is a good move. Oh, yeah, that's going to lead to damage and set blades.
Ooh. Scary. Yeah, K2 just backs off. SA is on full offense right now.
But obviously, Ino does have the horizontal advantage, which is obviously horizontal chemical love.
Oh, man. Good box from K2 here.
Good blitz. Recovers in time, though.
Yeah. Oh, otter YRC.
Oh, catch the back dash.
Nice, just hits him low.
Yeah. Just escapes with the dive kick, or the dive.
All right, jumps off the beach ball.
My god, what am I watching?
It's like a demonstration at SeaWorld.
Oh!
Oh, nice. Hits him one side, ends in the other.
Ah, oh, the ball just... wasn't there to hit it, but...
Funny, K2 hasn't really converted to full damage yet, but he's just getting his hits in and playing slow, which is honestly, I think, perfectly acceptable game plan right now.
Yeah, both of these...
Ooh.
Both of these characters can be quite rushed down if they want to, but no.
That burst from SA was an interesting choice.
I feel like...
He had the potential to still end it, but...
Yeah. Oh. Oh god.
Yeah, Stroke the Big G trading with Dolphin.
Interesting, yeah. I thought, yeah, Stroke the Big G would just like straight up go under it. Oh god!
Nice, jump to damage. HS.
Oh. Oh, watch out.
The slide is covered by that. And here we go. K2 actually getting a full setup here. Oh yeah, you gotta be careful with that one.
That could potentially kill you. Nice back dash.
Right, back dash, good back dash.
I know.
Yeah, burst. He knows that SA could end him off that one hit.
Yeah.
Just doing everything he can to not hold that.
Yeah. Don't want Ino anywhere near you. Just keep her out.
Oh,
she's in. She's in.
The far away note. Lock him down enough to get in and start his offense. And this is where K2 should be sweating.
All right. Oh, OTGs.
Yes. That's
lucky break for K2.
Oh, tries to command throw it. Okay. So he tried to command throw his tech there. But May's jump arc, man. He was able to tech and jump right out of there.
Yeah, that's... Main's way of avoiding anti-air is jump more. Jump
more.
Higher.
Yeah. Yo, they're trying to air throw you. You just double jump there. There's no way they're getting that air throw.
Yeah. SA's thinking about it.
He's thinking, this is good. Take a little bit of time to think about it. I think SA, he knows once he gets his offense started, he's in there. But K2, like I said, he's spreading his neutral out. He's only once did K2 really convert into like a high damaging combo set play situation. Most of the time, it's just this runaway guerrilla warfare where he gets his licks in, gains the advantage, and plays comfortably. So,
yeah. We'll see.
Oh, nice. Right. I like how that had a sound effect for a little pose there. Oh, yeah. And that's what I'm saying. He just gives SA the benefit of the doubt. He knows.
Nice backdash.
Backdash into jump, and man.
These dolphin pressures. Oh, the dust!
Did he get hit jumping?
No, if he got hit, well, maybe... The damage! Oh, my God!
Oh, my God!
I don't think that's going to hit.
I don't think so either.
Yeah.
Yeah, but it recovers so fast, able to throw him still.
Nice 6P.
All right. SA's...
Oh, no!
Oh, no.
6P!
6P!
Oh, God!
Gosh, is not the ideal situation for May there.
Nice!
We'll just let this one speak for itself.
2K. Okay.
Yeah, 2K. Whoa, I didn't know she was like doing like a B-boy thing.
The B-boy thing? Yeah, low profile B-boy. Alright.
Alright. Yeah, both of them just choose to give each other the space. He's in there with stroke of victory, but still a scramble.
Yeah.
Ook! Ooh, hits him on the way down. Like I said, he doesn't even need full combos. He can just get those hits. But just as I say that, converts into a bad combo.
Yeah.
Oh, we're not blocking that.
No one's blocking that. All right. We get it. Ooh!
A lot of air attack situations for K2.
Yeah, air attack into otter, too. That was weird. Maybe he wanted to...
Oh, block the helicopter arms.
Ah, just not enough meter.
A quick turnaround from SA.
Quick 1-1. That reversal could have helped if he had 100 meter, but didn't get it.
They're kind of smiling, they know. Like, that was a little nutty. The scramble situations. It's a little hard to tell what's going to happen. Who's at advantage early? But
I think Mate has an advantage of mid-screen because I think
Because of the help. All right.
Now this situation.
Oh, good otter covering up the jump out. Yeah, nice. Punishes that on the way down.
Nice. 5P and here.
And converting to massive damage. SA.
Ooh.
Nice. Unable to punish.
But still failed the burst nonetheless.
Ooh. Yeah, he's backing up. He doesn't want... Oh, K2 with the pressure. That was honestly a very good approach with the beach ball covering it.
Oh god, jump S. Okay, otters. Wow, using RRC to get the approach. Right. Trying to check in with the JK right there.
Oh, the projectiles clash a bit there off screen.
Oh!
Beach ball. Oh!
The go burst. All right, what are you going to do with the resources? Try to go for the air throw.
He's going
to
go buck. That's what he's going to do.
Uh-oh. I don't know about that, VCL. You use all that meter that you just had. All
right, good beach ball to get rid of that note.
Yeah,
let's just hop over that one. Hop over that one as well.
Yeah. Jump H. Negative all penalty right. For Eno? Okay.
Yeah, it's funny because I could have sworn May was the one laming it out. Here we go.
Oh, God. Ooh. The ground mouse.
Yeah.
All right,
and
she's
SA needed that so badly. And that just was enough to close it out. K2 with his back against the wall now.
All right.
Of course, he is only one round from tying it up. Beach, we're going to see a lot of that.
Oh, God, this is going to hurt.
Yeah, it's going to hurt. Boom, boom.
Oh,
yeah.
Jesus.
All right, let's see what kind of setup he goes for. Yeah, he just wants to get the otter to stop primarily the jump out.
Oh, good block on the jump D right there. He does do it a lot, so obviously good awareness.
A little bit of buffering there from SA.
Oh, that's just the low attempt.
Oh my god. And he is hopping all over him.
Hopping all over the place. All right. Blocking. Mace trying to get out of that corner and he should.
Yeah.
It's not going to kill.
Not going to kill, but he's going to otter?
But
no, just...
Gets the otter bomb.
Oh man.
ACL, yeah.
K2, he just needs one hit, but yeah.
There it is.
I was going to say, it's still a very scary situation for him, because you know, as soon as SA hits him, he could go downhill from there.
Yep.
And now,
that goes for
last
both.
Possible round.
I don't know about
that. Yeah, I don't know about that either. That was a little scary.
Again, like I said this yesterday and like during the team thing, but like, oh, nice conversion. Almost. But like, yeah, K2 never goes for overhead kiss command grab. Like, never. It's all these, like...
Yeah. But, you know, he's just saving it for that one moment.
All right. The last gimmick. Lots of note.
Fortunate that he had to block that, but the beach ball is so clutch for him right now. Bouncing all over the place. All
right. Dashes.
Yeah, this could be bad, actually. Because now he's got a... bank on building that 50 meter and try and maybe scheme a dead angle or something. Oh, no, air tech is...
Yep.
All right, never mind.
Oh, God!
Oh, yes, and he's able to bob and weave the note just
all
barely.
Right.
That, it's going to come back.
Stay close
out. Hits him.
She was crouching.
Oh.
All right,
yeah, they're
the
both
beach ball.
Oh, no!
Good block with the...
Okay, so right. He's got burst. He might just choose to spend it.
Oh!
Very, very, very close match.
Just got the burst.
Scary.
Maybe he wasn't aware. Well, granted, you know.
It was a little hard for him to choose when to spend it in that situation, definitely.
Yeah.
Okay.
Damn.
So, based off that, I would say that it's Peppery Splash for Psychotic next.
Yep. I guess so. Yeah.
So these guys played in the team tournament as well.
Team tournament.
They also played last
Dash Fest.
Every tournament they show up to, their
most Red Bull. Name it, and you know if they're both of them are there, they will cross path because they're both good players. But yeah, both these players have been playing out a long time. Like, ever since... So, Peppery came in after Canada Cup 2015 into the Hamilton scene.
Then
started wrecking people. He was like the, I don't know, the hidden gem kind of thing. Just came out of
nowhere. At first he was the dark horse.
Dark horse, yeah. Came out of nowhere and then started wrecking people. And, yeah, this year he's still keeping that dominance. The dominance and, well, the strong presence, I should say. You know?
Yeah. This is going to be a very, very explosive match. Any moment. And when we saw it before, like I said, it looked like it could go either way. So
it could. And then the records show that they are, you know, back and forth. Yeah, it's going to be a fun one.
Take a deep breath. And this is going to be.
Let her in. All right, cool.
No, they get right at it.
2S to start off.
Okay. Oh, wow. Catching the backdash with the charge, Beak Driver.
Yeah, I can't backdash those. Beak Driver will catch you.
Okay.
Lots of 2S here from Peppery. Trying to probably catch Beak Driver. Well, you gotta play careful.
Just wants to keep at least half of his life.
Blocks the.
Nice. Baits him in with that eat. Wire sees. All right. 6P still able to block.
Stuff to approach here with 2S.
Oh. Great defense for Peppery right now.
Good mix of defense right there. But then gets tagged out while trying to escape.
He just wasn't able to get started. And that's what it comes down to.
That's how it is.
Psychotic. Has the burst, which means he's able to make a mistake.
Or he's gonna do the up RTL, burst RTL. Ooh, okay. All the way to the corner?
Yeah.
Yo, coast to coast?
Nice.
All right, close enough.
Finishing it, but you know.
Yeah. I don't know if the damage was worth it for 4 coins that he has spent, but we'll see.
Ooh. A little bit of fast paced spacing from Pepperly's Bosch coming out.
Yeah. So far, Sakata is definitely getting the advantage with the damage output here.
That was a very good backdash.
Mm.
Oh, all right. This is a chance to get started. Never mind.
Yeah. Not capitalizing on those like hits he's getting. There
okay,
we go.
Just go for the treasure hunt. And
all right. Is this the starter?
Ow.
Yep. This is going hard.
Ow.
All right.
You brought it up before.
Yeah.
Man, he actually did it.
Yeah.
Oh!
Oh!
All right.
Okay,
nice.
Okay.
That was a cute little conversion from Peppery Splash. Close it out there. It's like Psychotic nowhere near burst, so he's got to bring the fight to Peppery Splash.
Yeah.
Oh, man. He was trying to get a 6K at Whip Punish that, maybe.
Beak Driver doesn't care.
Yeah, Beak Driver never cared. Yeah.
Yep.
Exactly. Oh. All right. Gets the coin, gets a 6K, and he will take him all the way where he needs to be, in the corner.
Level 3. Watch out.
Yeah, gotta watch it. Oh, bam. Yeah, that hurts.
Ends with the level 3. Overhead.
Oh,
yeah,
nice.
Raise it. Nice.
You know, every time someone stands that, I'm so happy for them.
Yeah.
Because that's a life or death situation. Right.
Peppery does like ending the round with that, too. So.
All right. Nice.
Gets knocked down again.
It's going to be a tough one. Oh, just jumps off.
Tries to air throw. Oh. All
right, Psychotic got all the meter he needs to go crazy. Yeah, it doesn't even have to wire see that.
All right. Level 1 misfinder for Peppery Splash right now. Yeah. Still playing with it, though. Still doing it. No coins left, but air throws in. All right. First game, Peppery.
Psychotic never really got a chance to spend any of that meter. I was kind of interested to see what he planned on doing. They go right back into it. Oh, man.
They play this match enough times. They know the idea of what they need to do. mistakes they made.
Wanted to get that jump dust knockdown, but just a little bit too late.
Mm-hmm. Oh, okay.
Yeah, we saw that earlier.
Yeah.
There's got to be a reason as to why he does it, or maybe. It's just a mistake, but
I don't know, but he did waste a misfinder level for that, but gets a corner. Yep.
Oh, yeah, just hits him low.
Tags him.
Yeah, those jump punches get that extra height.
Oh,
I think he tried to do it, but air throw this time.
Yeah,
or something. I don't think Psychotic was recognizing that situation from
that
before.
That was naughty right there.
Yeah, it was.
All right,
a little bit of cuteness coming out from Peppery Splash.
All right.
Oh,
jumps out. Listen, of there.
Jumps out again.
Yeah.
Honestly, I really respect that.
It's YYRC. It's not gonna be enough to.
Burst out. I think even he was unsure. That's why he burst it.
All right,
but I'm. Not exactly sure I agree with that, but oh, you know what? Fix my face. All of a sudden, it's a good idea.
All right.
With all hindsight. Boom, boom.
Oh, no. Just a bit too. Yep.
Oh, my God. Psychotic with the. I don't know if he has to be that low, but I feel like he should have just let it rip.
Too eager there.
Yeah.
And then, of course, the burst was. His burst gone now. See if he gets it back by the end of this.
Nice. Ooh, just throw him right out of that pole vault.
Yep.
Heavy splash with all the momentum.
Interesting.
Drops it, but he's still in there.
Yeah, still in there.
Oh.
Interesting. 2 H anti-air, not 6 B.
He's got to watch out for that wrist gauge. Any open up, and
yeah,
he is.
Full. That's a full wrist gauge. Yeah, good point. Nice backdash, YRC.
All right.
Conversion. Double coin. All right, he has level 3.
Oh,
just jumps in normally.
It's over. Yeah.
And there you have it. Peppery, 2-0. Alrighty. Nice clean match, except for that one little scramble, but there you have it.
Yeah, that was. It's always hard to tell between the two.
Mm-hmm.
But man, Peppery, it felt like even though Psychotic did get some high damage combos in there, Peppery was just able to convert that risk gauge into huge damage.
Yep.
And he made his hits count a little bit more. So, or some maybe a lot of it more, honestly.
Yeah.
All right, so we got Lofo versus SA. So this is a team kill.
Team kill, Ottawa team kill.
Unfortunate, but when you make it this far in tournament and your boy also makes it this far in tournament.
Exactly.
No hard feelings between the two of them, of course, but.
Ottawa had a strong showing in general. Like, there was few in top 16 and then, yeah.
And here we are, only one may prevail.
May progress, yes. Both players, I'm sure they fought each other numerous times. Kai versus Eno.
So we're going to definitely see that player meta game come into
potentially.
Play,
you know. On paper, Kai can, without No, Kai can definitely disrespect Eno all day, whatever. But once Note's out, like other characters, Kai will have to hold that. And then when Kai's on the offense, you know, it comes to the SA, the player's defensive, you know, defensive strength, I should say.
Yeah.
And then SA definitely has that. He has the abilities to clutch it out too. So, you know, I want to say I kind of like SA on this one, but who knows?
Who knows? Who knows? Honestly, I think this is the first time I've seen them play in tournament. I'm sure they've definitely played in tournament before, but.
Mm-hmm. Yep. I've seen when Phil Sage comes out. Yeah, Sage comes out. I've seen that happen between SA.
Yeah.
But Lofo versus SA. Here we go.
Right, 2HS immediately. Mm-hmm. I guess he just expected the aggression to come out.
He's in. Blocking. All right. Yeah, there we go. Gets in. Immediately bursts out.
Oh. Puts him in a bad spot because of that stun edge.
Yeah. The thing about Eno is that Eno player doesn't mind. Well, obviously having the burst for defensive option is nice. But then technically, as a character, she becomes almost stronger without burst because of those FD cancels in the air.
Yeah.
So. Oh no! Alright. Still can take the hit, but there's the jump D.
You're not blocking that.
Yeah, not, and that's a heavy hitter starter too. Oh, there it is.
That hover dash.
He's gonna get the burn. Never mind.
He gets it in time for next round at
least.
So
it's true.
He has that to look forward to, I guess.
That goes for Lofo too, though. He pretty much almost has it back. Yep, a little damage there. Puts him to the corner. Pack dashes away, but then back just into the corner.
Low profile's the vapor thrust. Hits him out of the tech.
Yep. I think that's an OS as well. Oh, there it is. The ref 2 changes for Eno.
All right, yeah. Didn't exactly get a lot of mileage out of that burst. He's going to get the Oki here.
He's blocking.
Ooh, nice.
All right. Is this a start?
Okay. Oh, all right. I like that.
All right, put her in the grinder. Oh, man. Under the far S right there. Okay, can't make any more mistakes. Wow, ooh, jump H.
Above and behind, jump H coming through.
That guitar. Yeah. So that command grab, it's not technically a command grab anymore for Ino. It's a proximity unblockable, just like Pots. Or Pots. Right. Well, I guess Pots too, but Pots Heat Knuckle. So that's the reason you can combo into it now. Which is good for combo extension. The only quote-unquote nerf for it is that you can blitz it now, technically. Yeah. But, you know. But it's only the ground one. So if you do the air one is still a command grab. So that's the reason why SA can still do those option selects to catch burst, catch text, and such. All right. So that was a quick first game. Let's see if Lofo can make some adjustments here.
Get air there.
Yeah. That's the first hit. Oh, it doesn't block the dust. Immediately burst out, yeah. Doesn't want to give SA the turn that he wants. There it is
nice.
With the
getting
air
a lot of mileage
again.
Out of jump air. Air. Yep.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, there
nice.
It is again. Good damage. Yep.
Oh.
Beefy damage. Oh, no.
Nice. You can see him cranking those fuzzies.
Yep. All right. All right. Even on life, more or less. Oh, wow. Again with the jump K.
Yeah, that sucks. Because Lofo finally had a chance to get started. Here we
There's
go.
Just a new 6H. Okay,
oh,
drops
yeah,
the combo.
Just a bit.
Gets in. Jump D.
All right,
good.
Block. He needed
yeah.
to block that.
Oh. Yeah. Lofo's not getting hit by too much of those because I think he knows that SA loves doing those jump D.
Good tech forward from SA regardless.
Oh! Yeah. Little miss input there from SA.
He wants to take the round.
Ah,
yeah.
Yep. All right.
And SA ahead. Like quite a bit.
Oh, wow. There it is. There's a try jump right there. That is pretty dirty.
Yeah. Now.
Oh. Catches the back dash. tries to go for the side switch, but had the right idea, but
right,
jump
the two
H
of them
again.
Fighting to keep the other in the corner.
Can't mash out in time.
Oh, yeah, he had to.
Yeah, to PRC that.
Two dust to crouch under the HCL. Yep. Yeah, I think he was trying to block the burst there.
Okay. Still has the burst. Go!
Yeah. All right, recovers a little bit from that, but he's got his work cut out for him.
Nice.
All right, that's
okay.
A good way to start it off.
Okay.
Oh, yeah, just lets him fall to the ground because he's too weary of the conversion here, and Lofo. Yeah.
There it
nice,
is.
And he's going to be able to close it out. All right, so you go from getting your burst thrown to coming back. That's a good look.
Yeah, he's like.
This could be a tremendous amount of momentum, especially because your opponent's a bit worried now.
Yeah, but. Still low on burst. That's still a fact. Okay. Oh!
Calls out the
yeah.
blitz.
He definitely reacted to the normal blitz, so. Oh, there's a jump D again. It's gonna hurt.
Yep.
Still no burst. I don't think he's gonna get it back a bit. By the end of this round.
Blocks across it, but gets open up anyways.
Yeah. Still looking. Couple drops from SA, but Gee. Right now still looking good.
Enough to close it out here? No. The OTG takes it.
There you have it. 2-0 for SA. Good showing from Lofo. He definitely there were some places that he knew what SA is doing, but there is a limit on what you can react to, what you can predict, and, you know, with their approaches.
And honestly, I felt like Lofo still had some pretty good blocks. Like I said, blocking the cross-up, but just getting opened up low immediately after. It's,
yeah.
You know.
We only got to see Kai's new 6H once, which apparently it's like both buff and a nerf. Where
yeah. Like, I've heard the word different.
Yeah, it's different. Like, you can try using it like the old 6H, but it recovers slower, so it doesn't, apparently it doesn't safe jump. It's not really jump, but you know what I mean.
Yeah.
Safe setup against DPs is better as old one, but, you know, you can still, it's still a plus 7, so people will have to respect after that. Such and such.
And also more horizontal range, so the option to go into it off of a farther block string as
well. Yeah, moves him forward, so. So, We got SA again. Stays still sitting there. And then Peppery Splash. Johnny versus Zeno.
Oh, man. It's going to be a whole lot of someone getting opened up for a lot of damage. Both sides trying to block but getting opened up. You know.
This is going to be...
Oh, two slash. Peppery Splash likes...
Yeah, he really liked the 2S to start off the round, and it worked out for him because they called out the Stroke the Big Tree. All right. Gets in there. Nice blitz.
Oh, no.
Gets a level 2.
Oh, and that's very worth it for SA, if I do say so myself.
Yeah.
Yeah, that jump dust. Here we go. He's going to get to hit him with that note. And the note whiffs, unfortunately, and he's able to get up a trade.
Mm-hmm. But still advantage for SA.
Oh.
Just a little too far. All right, gets hit by the coin anyway.
Oh, nice. He whiffed the jump 2K, but still... just whiffed the 2K, able to still convert.
It's that fast.
Yeah. That was... Oh, man.
All right. 2S from SA this time. 2H, yeah.
Yeah. Try to maybe hit his throw west there.
He's
getting some big hits with that. Speak of big hits.
Being hit, yep. This round apparently is a Johnny's turn.
Oh, yeah.
It's a turn-based game, apparently.
Johnny, still his turn.
Okay.
Unable to finish, yeah, but not a whole lot SA can do in this situation.
Yeah. Let it rip with that level 3.
Oh, but SA's... Oh,
back dash RC. Oh!
SA just wants to maybe it's contested at least.
Yeah, I don't know. That I got this burst.
SA has a tendency to burst on low HP. He does definitely have the character to get something started afterwards, but he just...
I don't know.
You gotta wonder. All right.
Wow.
All right. They'll both take that.
Gets in. Yep. Wave punishes. Bursts
good
out.
That he burst him on the other side.
Oh! That try jump. The literal try jump. All right. Is this round SA's turn? There's a jump deep. No burst. This is going to do a lot of damage. He can't hit with the super. Yeah. Oh, doesn't even need it.
Doesn't
good damage.
It.
First match of SA. So all in right. teams, we did see that SA did have at least a first one advantage over Peppery. We see again, first to one, so far SA has an advantage.
It's up to Peppery to make those adjustments.
Yeah.
For sure. And already, good backdash.
Yep. It's in.
Challenges it this time. Oh man, that would have been a very tricky conversion to get. So he just opts for the tech chase.
Yep, you're in this corner this time. All right. SA, you gonna hold on to that burst.
Two side.
Oh, okay.
Whiffing all sorts of stuff.
Yeah, TK Cycle Crusher, or what I'm gonna call it. Oh my god, wake up.
Oh,
level 3 miss.
Just
fire.
Wanted to finish him off with it, but it's.
All right.
Uh-oh.
Oh, yeah. Catches him. Oh no.
Oh,
the dust.
Yeah, just not enough to kill somehow.
Yeah.
But he gave him a little bit of a stare down before he let it rip.
Yeah. Like,
Now you're doing something.
Double dash into throw.
All right. Honestly, that drop was very unfortunate because now he's playing the.
This is the IAD.
Yeah. And you see combo drop resulting in the other person in the corner.
Oh no.
This is the worst possible way to go.
Okay.
Treasure hunt. Steal those question marks.
Misses, but still. In there.
Oh,
nice back dash.
He's finding ways to deal with it now. So,
yeah. So one on each.
One each. There was a time when Peppery dropped his combo, SA teched out, had him in a corner situation, dropped his combo, and then Peppery teched out, got him in the corner situation. So I can't say that SA necessarily played too poorly there, but the drop was catastrophic for him.
It's definitely a... Minimal mistakes allowed.
Damn.
Knockdown. Not blocking those lows.
Oh, 6P clash.
Wow, that caught the hover.
All right, so 2 slash air to air. Gets this pretty good
conversion. This is going to hurt.
Yeah, he's done.
He's not going to even take the Just combo it out. It's okay.
And he's still nowhere near burst. This is...
Oh, that was fast. All right. Match point for Peppery. All right.
Oh, no.
Oh, man. Those
that
two
was his chance to escape.
Those 2S really working out for Peppery. Even catching something really little hovers. Go burst. All right. Lots of resources here for Peppery. Blocking those.
Yeah, he's been dealing with the jump dust.
I think
past two games.
Maybe he's realizing it's more of a comfort thing from SA. Like, he definitely likes doing those jump D a lot.
Uh-oh.
All right. Mid screen conversion. We got those.
Nice.
Still in the corner. It's Y. Nope. 2S. That's it. Oh,
yeah.
Okay. All right. Got it.
I don't want to count him out, but it's not looking. Yeah.
There you have it. Peppery Splash taking it 2-1. Yeah. It's just that game. It's just turn-based sometimes, you know?
Yeah, Peppery Splash. And if there was one adjustment, I'd have to say that counted the most. It was just dealing with the jump dust, man. When SA got started, Peppery was able to backdash, you know, in some situations of RA.
Yep.
Just, and even blocking it, honestly.
It's crazy.
Oh.
We got winner's finals
next. This is a
next. Classic. We got winner's finals next.
This is a classic.
Is it? To be honest, I haven't seen Peapock in winner's finals ever.
Oh, I don't mean like them being in winner's finals. I just mean like back in the ANC days.
Oh,
these
yeah.
These guys faced the tournament so much.
Right. ANC. Rip ANC.
Rest in peace.
Not dead, but yeah,
you know.
We know. Yeah. But
world, specifically. World. We'll just say that.
Peapock versus Ryan Cannon. First, just three. Viking versus Coom. I don't know what to say about this. Coom to me is still a new character.
Yeah.
Viking is
for sure.
Old but new character.
Yeah, redesigned.
And
so you got a new paint job.
I got that eye patch and everything, eye goggle.
Oh.
I don't know.
Yo, I'm going to be honest. Everyone could debate about how she is balance wise, but the new design is so sick. I love the
yeah.
new design a lot.
Ryan Cam plays her so well too. Like, I'm excited watching his Viking.
Yeah, he's putting in a lot of work. Of course, she's still very fresh. Ryan Ken putting in the hours. So they're going to go straight into it, I presume. I'm going to hop in my mech suit real quick.
Yep. Get my Gundam. All right, get that teapot patented green. Green Coom, and then we got a little rip with the opening. So cool.
Yeah, it's long, but it's definitely...
Nah, it's worth it.
It's worth it.
Whoever animated this was a Viking player.
Yeah,
it's like,
sure.
Yo, I want my mage to look really cool.
Yo, let's go.
All right. First match, here we go. Winner's finals. All right, lots of high boosts. Two beats.
Crank that 2-piece. All right, yeah, the gun to go under that. This is going to be some interesting zoning for
balls
both.
Versus guns. All right. Oh man.
Oh, nice.
That means
good instant blocks coming out from teapots already.
Nothing too crazy so far. Oh, there's the counter hit.
Yeah, just gonna.
Interesting.
Unfortunate.
I wonder if there's any adjustment Coom has to make against the Viking because she is a lightweight character.
Right.
Oh, there's a frame tab. Ryan Ken's been gaining a lot of people with that. 2H, I believe, into hook. It's
Ooh.
Got
ouch.
Eight.
Ouch.
And then convert. Yep.
Oh, 60 just OTG. He stared down that Azami. He even let him hold it for a little bit there.
Oh, okay. I don't know about that burst. Keeps her in the corner, though. So
it's a momentum thing. Let's just write it off
All
as
right.
that.
Oh.
Yeah.
Yeah,
he's very
the
wary
Azami.
Of it.
Or read the Azami. Oh, chips her out.
Chips him out, yeah.
She still had the meter, but Ryan decides to let it chip out. 6-H, you start.
Backdash that. Yeah. Nice. And he's just waiting. Yeah.
The fireball's gone now.
Throws
him into the corner. Nice.
Let's see.
A little too heavy. Coom, I guess, is a heavyweight character, so... both of these characters have to adjust their combos to each other's. Oh, okay.
Nice.
Oh!
Honestly, it wasn't too bad because he was whiffing a special. All right, let's see what kind of... Yeah, he has to go... Yeah, see, even he went for the punch to try and juggle, but...
Yeah, that's only for lightweight. You have to just go straight into S, I believe. Ooh, give her the clap! Or just... Yeah. Oh, wow. Wave punishes, but doesn't get the conversion.
There we go.
Yep. That's not going to kill. That's not going to kill.
Ooh.
Yeah. Even with OTG, yeah. It's not... It gives you a hard knockdown, but it's arguably one of the lowest damaging super. There's the dust!
Ow. Okay. All he needs
again!
Is one, but...
All right.
Yeah.
Okay.
A little ambitious, but he was, you know, trying to make it happen off basically no life, so...
One piece.
He's got his burst.
Okay. Mike with the burst. So has those. I don't know if Ryan Kang's going to get back any, but we'll see. Oh.
All right. Unable to get the jump slash. Yeah.
Okay.
Good instant block.
Yeah.
T-Bot told me that he actually took Baikin into the lab to make sure that he was prepared for all of her follow-ups and whatnot.
Okay.
So we're going to definitely see a little bit of that.
Yeah.
Two-piece him out of maybe a throw attempt. We'll never know.
Ryan Kent's really good at, like... Nice. Yeah. He's making sure that, like, those Fireball Oki characters doesn't get free Oki. But here comes...
Yeah. Should be enough to end it.
Yep. Has burst.
Yeah.
Yep.
It was one of those situations where you might as well... Because I'm pretty sure he was dead as soon as the HS landed.
Yeah. And obviously doing the combos with the JPP, you know. To make sure he doesn't get tagged. All right, first Kane's teapots.
All right, here we go.
Tatami.
Nice backdash into Tatami.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, just stuffing him out of whatever he tried to do there.
Yeah, maybe throw again.
Yeah, throw would be my guess. Yeah.
Yep. Got some blow. Burst out immediately. Oh!
Nice. Should we get
Susanna's out of there.
Yeah, two punch. Not early enough. Like
oh,
you said,
there it is.
Kuhn's weight playing a big factor here in the conversions.
Wow.
Oh. Yeah, good conversion. I needed to go into that, but...
Okay.
Combo game.
Oh, no. Wasn't blocking the overhead from the second hit.
Yeah.
Even with Hellfire, still not going to kill.
Yeah.
I don't know if that even added any damage. Oh, punches her. Like, nah. Wow.
Shanking
that was
him.
That was the low, too.
Yeah.
So.
You have to call it out.
That was a pure rock, paper, scissors right there for both players.
Yeah, and it's good that T-Pots is not letting him get away with that. Yeah,
there
not,
you go.
not letting him get away with it.
Yeah. Here it is. Conversion. One more. Ooh. Okay.
And that,
still good damage.
Yeah. Oh, still able to get the conversion, and that's another thing. T-Pots, good conversion game for whom?
Yeah, the delayed overhead. Yeah, because of the super flash, pretty sure you can't Azami that. Probably the best answer Kuhn has against Azami. Alright.
Gun. Shoots him with the gun.
Yep. Gun. Them cannons.
The good air-to-air challenge there.
Yeah, block.
Oh, yeah. Stuff the run-in with the jump slash facing.
Oh, gets caught.
And my T-Bot's having consistent answers for Suzerain.
Yeah. At least he's searching now. Oh, catches him. Gosh. Oh, that's gonna combo. Yep. That's his blow. Chase down. Trying to. Lots of guns from Ryan Ken. I don't know what he's trying to achieve with that, to be honest. Like, it does go under the Kuhn fireball, but, like. Oh, God. 2P?
Oh! Here we go. I'm not sure if he has anything special
prepared
for
that.
Yeah,
that's not gonna convert well. Danger time. Yeah, kinda,
oh, yeah, he's not trying to hold two mortal counters there.
Oh! Oh! Okay, dead angle's out.
Gets caught trying to do something other
still
than block.
Still not gonna kill.
Oh. Oh my god. This is scary. Yeah.
6-8!
It was good. It was good. He saw the 2 slash. He knew, this guy's gonna do delay to Tommy. I'm gonna instant block it and immediately make him regret that decision.
That's 6-8 though. 2-0 so far for T-Pots. 6-6 again! Grandpa Viper.
Yeah, no, he's not trying to mess with that.
Nah.
All right. Ryan Kent trying to find his way out of the corner.
Suzerain's out. All right. Keep some corner pressure going with the wire seat. Okay.
Nice. Unable to get anything off that.
Mm-hmm. Nice. Oh!
Man, he has some very good spacing with the ball there.
Yeah. All right. Loathe. That's the low again. A little too far to get the conversion into 2H, but he... Oh, he still gets it!
Yeah. And there, he was able to zombie it there, but there was a bit of space. So.
There was, yes.
All right.
All right.
Nice, good.
Okay.
Oh! Honestly, he'll take that.
Throw, yep.
Okay, T-Pots is in control.
T-Pots?
Like, firm control.
T-Pots looking confident.
He's the one driving this car. Oh, nice. Okay. It gets the instant block. I guess decides to challenge. Ryan Ken on it. All right, here we go.
Yes. Oh!
So he told me specifically that if he's unsure of whether he can get the knockdown or not, he will attempt to get chain resets like that.
Yep. Smart.
Ball just goes away because it gets hit.
Yep. Yeah, it's only Kumball. That doesn't... didn't place the Kumball well.
Man, burst.
Okay. Nice! Not the right idea. Alright. Lots of tatamis. Oh, watch out! Still there. Hayabusa's. Wow, 6-8. Okay.
Contested. Mm. Alright, he's just jumping around. Yeah, Ryan can sense maybe an air dash in there, but it's good.
It's still there. Yeah, it's still there.
Oh,
Super Ball is still there even if he gets hit. Hayabusa? Low.
Nice. Should be able to convert this into
It's not going to kill, though.
Not going to kill.
Mm.
Alright, that's only like minus 3 or 4, that follow up there.
Yeah. Oh, Hayabusa. Right.
Yeah, gets out. And throws him.
Wow, the damage. And T-Pot moves on to grand finals with 3-0.
T-Pot's. Okay. Look, man. T-Pot's actually a very clutch player. So the fact that he's sitting in grand finals winner's side is. His odds of winning the tournament just went up greatly.
Yeah.
Let's just say that much.
And loser's final is going to be Peppery versus Ryan Can as well. So. Which T-Pot has experience playing them too, right?
Oh,
so
yeah.
he won't be going into a blind fire, like.
That was very convincing as well. I'm not sure between Ryan Ken and Peppery Splash who would be the better one to face T-Pot's potentially win. I mean, Ryan Ken just got 3-0, but I don't think it's necessarily like a read on T-Pot's part. He just played very well.
It's hard to say.
But
I think
he definitely had answers to that bike and stuff, man. He had answers.
Going by character? Johnny's better going up against Coom than Viking.
I think.
As a player, you know, both are good contesters.
But first, they must duke it out.
Yeah.
It's not even about who would do better, it's about who wins. So here we go.
Right now, gotta look out for what's in front of them. Literally in front of them.
Oh, yeah.
Because we got some godlike head-to-head setup for
for the win.
Give each other the handshake.
Handshake.
Where'd our streamer go? That's fine.
No, he's there.
Oh, okay. All right. We got some crowd cheering too. Okay, first match. Losers finals. 3 out of 5.
Oh,
5 candy.
Anti-air, yeah, that was a little strange. Nice defense.
So,
from instant blocks to FDing.
So in winners top 16, Ryan Kent is the one who sent Peppery Splash into losers. So
I asked Ryan Kent personally about it. He told me it was a nail biter set.
Yeah, I would assume so. Not just because of the character, but okay.
Nice. So unable to either of them unable to really capitalize on that, but just as I say that, Peppery comes out on top.
Crosses under. Air throw is nice. Okay. Respecting him a little.
Nice. Hits him out of that.
Interesting. Cancels into Suzuda and then grabs.
Hitami whiffs. Or the backdash involving it. But
a little too far.
Whoa.
Could have punished that landing on the whiff Y, technically, I think.
Yeah.
Besides. All right. Nice smash out. There it is.
Scissor hand and throw. Tommy, yeah,
whoa.
He's got to adjust his timing a little bit on that.
Jump H.
Alright.
Is that a fuzzy setup? Looks like it almost.
Yeah.
I don't know what he would have got off of it, but...
I think it was TKO's onset.
Ah.
Yeah, that's that. That's yeah, but he stood right. It anyway, so that was good.
Alright.
Ooh, that was scary.
Just a little too far. Oh, there it is!
Run it back.
All right, if it doesn't work the first time, try it again. All right.
No, Ryken has a bit of a burst advantage, but other than that, it really is just about who gets the game started.
Ooh, Susanen threw that misfire.
Land 2K, unable to convert despite the counter hit. Oh, just ducks it.
Yeah.
With peppery splash.
Level 2? Alright, gets the damage.
Nice blocks. Oh.
Yeah, that's only like minus. Not enough.
Yeah.
All right, Charger
Hunt. Here we go. Steals the... I don't know what that says.
It says nothing in Japanese.
Oh.
All right.
Here we go.
Ooh. Ooh, good damage. Couldn't even burst that.
Yo, and you get to see the slow-mo little symbol there.
Yep.
So it says nothing. Hmm.
Yeah. I thought it would be like her little like sake bottle that she carries.
That would have been really cool.
Yeah. But it's all good. Wow. We're on a band here with 5P. Hmm. Okay.
Mm.
He's zombies. Okay. Oh, that counter hit.
All right. Yeah, he just waits, honestly. Yes. Yeah. Peppery Splash is in the driver's seat. Let's just say that.
Unblockable.
Oh, unblockable. Yep. He has a zombie.
Yep.
Yeah. Nope. Unable to use it.
Can you unblock? Can you Azami the unblockable?
I don't think so, actually. I'm not sure.
I'm not sure either, to be honest. I'm curious to know. But,
That was an interesting burst coming out of Peppery Splash, but just wants to get started, really.
Yeah, he wants to keep the momentum, but... Ooh,
good counter blitz. I think he needed that.
This is a jump pass.
Credit throw. All right. A little bit of spacing for the time being, and
level 3 misfires.
Able to convert it.
Mm. Drops it.
There's a down.
Yeah. Oh, PRCs. Oh, okay.
Yeah, you'll see that going over her head a lot. At least at that range.
Okay.
Just grips him.
It's not going to get... Oh, gets out. Okay, this might be the little...
Yeah, shoot the gun.
Free escape that Ryan can need it. There's a zombie.
Here we go. Yeah, he's got it. Yeah, he's getting ready for an air tech situation there.
Okay.
All right.
Yeah, but it's obviously with level 2, level 3, misfiner, like, anything can convert into damage, so it's just, can't let your guard down like that.
It's looking hard for Ryan Ken right now.
All right. Oh, a little too far on the tummy.
Yeah, yeah, he's been messing up the tummy timings on Johnny's wake up.
Yeah, I don't know what if Johnny's anything special for, like, the bike, but there's a counter hit, doesn't convert. Okay.
Nice.
Yeah, instant block on those 6K. Tatami.
Oh, man, that time I'm sure it was the backdash, but it also could have been the timing as well. You've seen that whip before. Yeah, follow up.
Oh,
dash
under
Tatami and puts him in a. Yeah.
Can't reach the burst.
Yo, Peppery blocks burst all day.
All day.
Ow.
Nice conversion.
Okay. Ryan Ken has to fight for his tournament life right here.
Yeah.
Honestly, if he brings it back, I will be very surprised.
All right, matches out.
Throw. He's getting a little bit of his offense start here. Yeah. Oh.
Ooh,
nice. Just throws him out of the 6K. All
right. Black beat. He'll take it though.
Yeah. Just
runs under again. All right, it's gonna be damage. Misses it. Okay.
Yeah, his backs up, gets hit by Tommy, but able to get the air throw out.
All right, nice. Azami, there you go.
Yeah, wouldn't have been at the range to convert there.
Okay.
All right,
convert that.
He's gotta get into a super. Oh, more slash. Either way.
Whichever works. All right, still staying alive.
He's hanging in there.
Yeah. Still a burst for Peppery Splash.
Yeah, it's funny. Oh, you're going to crouch under it, eh?
Yeah. But let me trip you there. All right.
All right.
In the corner. Not. Oh, backdashes this 2H.
Wow, recognizing the gap or maybe the misspacing, but.
Yeah.
Man.
Ooh, Susanen into the dash again. Okay. ROCs? Oh, see, guards out. Wow, air Azami. Okay.
Nice. Those low Azamis are coming pretty clutch. I guess nice mind
there.
There
you go. Okay. Yeah, a little more use out of those dash follow-ups after Suzura. But just gonna... That's gonna whiff.
Yeah, it's gonna whiff. And I'm not sure if he has the damage closed out here, but that will definitely do it.
There you have
Pepper's Splash taking a 3-0.
3-0 from
very,
Pepper's Splash.
Very strong showing Pepper's Splash.
But still, third place from Ryan Ken using Baiken.
Using Baiken. And that's what you got to take away from this. Baiken, very, very new. And not and people haven't really figured out how to get knockdowns off of everything, what's finite, what's not, you know. And you can see he's even playing around the fact that he doesn't necessarily have that knowledge. He's waiting for the attacks he knows.
Yep.
Too high up to combo. Well, that was pretty good, honestly.
Maybe he needs a new name, Ryan Baiken.
Yeah, Ryan Baiken. Nah, man. He'll be forever be the Ryan Ken. I know he had, like, a bunch of funny different names he entered as, but...
Of course.
Now that he's sponsored, I think he'll be sticking with...
Sponsored by TTT. But, yeah. Today's been, like, one heck of a day. Yesterday, too, to be honest. Like, lots of Guilty Gear action. The pool matches were crazy. Teams were crazy. And now this top eight, like... People at home, I hope you guys have been enjoying this because I know
yes,
I have been.
I've been enjoying it as well. Teams was awesome. Of course, the competition yesterday was great. And now here we have, and honestly, I don't think anybody had teapots on their fantasy bracket for winner's side grand
finals.
I don't
think so either.
But like I said, so teapots came to, like, we had a Guilty Gear DJ at my house on Friday, and he bodied us so hard. And honestly, after that, I was definitely thinking that, like, you at least make top four, so.
Yeah. And now here we are, grand finals. Teapot's winner side and Peppery Splash loser side. This is gonna be one hell of a match. So, I don't think they fought each other in this tournament at all, actually.
Yeah.
So.
I know they've clashed at Red Bull.
They have?
Maybe off stream, but I know, man, they... I know they flash Red Bull.
Peppery does have quite a bit of the aura ahead of him if he wants to take all
of this.
He's
got the character to do it, though.
He does.
He's got that damage. He's got those mix-ups. The pressure game. Peppery's, and the fact that he just blocks every burst.
Yeah. Yeah.
I think players, when you face Peppery Splash, just try and scheme your burst a little bit harder than right when you get hit by a big starter because he's watching.
He's watching.
He's watching.
He's really good on picking up on those people's, like, tendencies.
All right. We're getting started here. These two taking their time in the neutral, just trying to counterfoot to each other.
Already cornered here. Nice use of FDA. I actually like that. Uses resources, obviously, but it's not bad. Oh, wow. Can't get out. Still gets the knockdown situation. Burst out. All right. Okay. 6-H.
And then he... A bit late.
Oh, no. Yeah, too far. Oh, trying to back that out. Lots of stare down from here.
Peppery Splash is able to convert regardless of the situation. Some of his buttons, you know, hitting in weird situations, but he's still able to either convert to a combo or a good air throw situation. So, Keybot's going to have to...
Keybot really has to find a comfortable range that he wants to be in, but that's really hard because obviously Johnny as a character has so much, covers so much of the screen, right?
And he can hit you for big damage at that range.
Yeah, like technically if Johnny with that dash that he has can't move around as much as other characters will, but in exchange he just controls space so much better than a lot of the cast.
Of course. And they even gave Johnny, you know, different stuff to deal with projectile game to stuff his ground movement in this version of the game, so.
Yeah.
Alright, full conversion from Peppery Splash. This is a scary situation for sure.
Do I? Oh, it doesn't even hit him. Yeah, that is a nerf that he, Johnny got from Rev.
Fortunate. Oh, just high boost out of there.
Alright.
Yeah, he's gonna convert that.
A little too much on the run. Right. First that. Yeah, that could have potentially led to death, so. Boom damage is no jokes. Back dash is out. Okay. The read on the blitz is not bad, but he needs to realize that needs to realize that he likes those 2S and 2Ds. Oh, there we go.
All right. It's 1-1. T-Pot's getting it started a little bit here.
Yeah. I feel like... okay. Coin starter. It skills a lot, so Black Beat and... Double hits, too. Yeah, so it's not going to give him the hard knockdown he wants, but he still has level 2, I believe. There it is. Okay. Whiff punishes the air Hayabusa. Misses. DRCs to make it safe. Now he's in the corner.
Oh.
Fireball just goes away.
Maybe tried to trick him that he was going to throw there, but T-Pot's still on the offensive here.
Yeah. Oh, God. Uh-oh. Level 2 misfires through the fireball. Steals that lipstick.
The lipstick, yeah.
Yep.
Yeah, I think he even waited a little bit there to maybe try and catch the burst.
Now it's just
there
can't
was,
burst.
Yeah, just yeah. There's not. And it's funny because he's even waiting to try and block at the start of that. Yeah. You know.
First blood goes to Peppery Splash.
Already on the path trying to reset this. I don't know. I'm pretty sure we're going to see a reset. Maybe not. But Pepper
Let's
Splash
see
is
how
very...
much adjustment T-Boss can
exactly.
make.
Exactly.
Right now.
It's really hard to say after the first game, of course.
Yeah,
it just runs up. Different.
Ooh, wow. Oh, no.
And that's what I'm saying. Even though that was a weird situation, Peppery Splash still managed to make it a good look.
All right. You're in this corner still. Okay.
Interesting.
Interesting indeed.
I want to say that was an error, but I'm not sure.
A couple of nerfs showing from both players, perhaps? Oh, wow. Fireball just went away. Oh, no.
Nice whip punish on that. That was pretty far away.
I think that might have been like the Grand Viper to read the misfire, but gets air thrown. Give him that coin. It was like, keep the change.
Yeah, keep the change. I got lots more next round.
All right.
Here we go. This is the first time we've really seen T-Pots get fully started.
Yeah. Good damage, too. And that's what we need. Like, there you go. All right. Can he convert?
Yes. Good airflow situation. Perfect.
Perfect.
Tip was a little bit getting started there.
Yeah. Two big combos and a good scramble situation. That's all you need. But then you got to put yourself in that situation. There you go. Box low.
Nice, and that sends him way higher now.
Nice. Gets Earth,
I think he wanted to throw him there, but good stuff from Peppery Splash in the timing there.
All right, gets hit with the misfire.
Just
tech trap.
Yeah.
Why? Okay, good burst. But then the three-quarter screen.
Gotta be a bit more wary of that.
Yeah, you don't get free fireball pressure against Johnny when he gets level 3. Like, there's overhead.
Nice.
Treasure hunt, yep.
Yeah, just closing it out.
Damn. Yeah, in that kind of situation, not much he can do.
Like,
T-Pot knows what he has to do.
He's done it.
But, you know, how do you get there?
Maybe just a little bit less fireball game in the neutral.
Yeah, especially... Gotta watch out for what level. So right now he's level 1, so he can be a little bit more overzealous with the fireball, but his fireball, level 2 right now, gotta watch out. Wow, he's still option going for the fireball. It's gonna hurt. Drop combos? Alright, now we're in this corner. The burst, no! Okay, Chippy's out. Okay.
Alright, here we go. All right.
Combo. Okay, that is a safe place to burst. This is why.
Oh, unblockable.
Yeah.
Yeah, he really didn't get a play there. I mean, like, he did damage, but after that unblockable's coming out, that was kind of the death sentence.
Yeah. Those unblockable setups, too. Peppery's been really working on it recently. It's really showing, too. To just close out the game is so strong.
All right, but all the offense in the world here from T-Pots, I don't think he wanted to.
Yeah, too close. All right, 2 PP into knockdown. There's a low. There's a convert off of it, though. All right, still in the corner. Can you get out?
All right, good blitz.
Right?
That's what he needed.
Oh,
nice.
Empty low. Calls out that blitz.
Oh my god.
No.
It's unfortunate that he just really wanted to whiff punish it, but just couldn't. All of a sudden, a complete reversal here.
All right. Hempery just playing really comfortable right now.
That could have been very scary if he had gotten that conversion to treasure hunt, as it would have ended it. Yeah.
Oh, okay.
He's getting rounds, but he needs to try and slow down the momentum of Peppery Splash and at least get a game on him before the reset.
Yeah. No punish on the 6H. Okay.
All right. Yeah.
Wow. Burst out the 2P. Wow. Okay. A little ballsy there, but maybe that kind of little risque movement is what he needs.
All right.
A little unpredictableness to throw Peppery off is something he needs, but Peppery's still looking. Can he convert?
Nice.
He
just
does.
Instead, going for the run-up.
There's overhead. All right, let's get it started. No, the fireball doesn't come out.
Uh-oh.
Life advantage for Teapots. However, so much resource for its memory.
All right, he's just going to keep doing high boosts when he can.
Yep.
Oh, man, a little bit too much of a weight. Yeah, he sends him throwing him.
I really want to see some non-charge blitz from Teapots, to be honest.
Yeah.
That goes for a lot of players.
All right, 6-8 gets YRC, but he gets outspaced.
It's not going to kill. Has burst, but obviously can't burst those. Okay.
Yeah, Peppery Splash waiting. Yes.
Yeah, he's waiting.
Oh, gets now Oh, good. Just
successful burst against Peppery.
And I'm pretty sure Peppery was using those jump punches to try and get him to whiff the burst, but
didn't even trade. All right, so quick bracket reset here from Peppery Splash.
Take a moment, go to character select something.
Just breathe.
Oh.
Nope, nope, just going it, going it. No, no. Teapots wants to go in. Wow, 6P to beat the Hayabusa kick? Damn. All right. Low, yep. Burst out. Oh my god. Peppery Splash with all these conversions just really working out for him.
Oh, yeah. YRC is unable to convert.
Okay.
Nice backdash. 6K, burst it. Yeah, could have been a bad spot.
Yeah. No whiff punish, but oh, there. Yeah. Even with that horizontal in the air, like, whom I think is just tall enough so that it hits anyway. Oh, this relentless corner pressure. Oh, no. No dust off that. Counter. I also kind of want to see, like, when he gets to, like, 2PP mash, like, instead of getting for a knockdown, I kind of want to see, like, a little bit of a reset situation as well.
Yeah.
But keep all that coin.
He's just got to watch out for
Gotta watch out for that. That.
That right there.
That thing. Yeah.
Oh, man. It's been all Peppery Splash since the start of this set. Teapots has gotten a couple of rounds off, including a perfect, but not enough.
Yeah. It's the corner pressure, but all right, 6-H YRC. Okay.
He wanted 6-P. Yeah, that was the right idea, just a bit too late.
Yeah.
That was nice.
Yeah. Okay. So those are coins.
Yeah.
Gets strong. Back dash out. There we go. Gets knocked down.
Should be able to
reversal.
Block.
Good blocks by Cam. Yeah, so hard to punish those. What? The coin? Okay, the coin.
So it just works out for Peppery in the end here.
All right, treasure hunt. It's not going to kill. Yeah.
Oh. Okay, he wanted
lucky
to
lucky break for Teapots, but instant blocked on the Hayabusa and gets thrown.
Yeah, it's... He's running away with it right now.
Yeah.
He took a little bit of a second, but he actually... I don't know. It's just not looking good for Teapots here.
It's a tough one, you know, to be honest.
The matchup, definitely.
I don't know if it's even the matchup. I think Kuma as a character definitely can win this, like, as Teapots has shown. But so far, as for player tendencies goes,
yeah,
Peppery's really making all of it. Like, he's making everything count.
And honestly, yeah, you just see Peppery. He's just on point with the spacing, on point with the awareness, situational awareness. So
I think I'm seeing a little bit of frustration from Teapots. I feel like he's throwing out lots of moves, you know. All right. Oh, no. All right, knockdown situation. He could have gone for the unblockable, but doesn't bother. Just throw our coins, empty throws. All right. 6-H. All right.
And he gets it.
Okay.
Nice.
Wow, the upper end takes the throw. Throw the sec. Okay.
Oh, yeah.
There
converts
you go.
That. Nice.
All right. 2-H. Puts it into the corner. Oh, wow. Still converts it anyway. Okay. Level 2. There goes the first. 6-H. To be honest, that is like, may as well contest it for that, right?
Yeah.
Wow, gets the throw. Didn't think he was in range for that. Lots
oh,
of.
Oh, the coin's whiffed, but it's not too big of a deal as.
Yeah.
He's just gonna keep chucking him.
Oh my yeah. god, there it is. There.
He's. Every splash is all over him to the point where he can go for repeated throws like that. He knows.
He knows.
Yeah, just gonna go right back into it. At this point, you know, might as well.
Wow. Just right now, Peppery just has answers for everything.
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 It's just clean play coming out of Peppery.
Yep.
Okay. He like, blocks everybody. There's some times when they don't burst and he goes for the block, but other than that, man, you don't see Peppery like get bursted a lot.
Yeah. It's not even like the play it's not even T-Bot's fault to be honest.
Yeah.
It's just like
No, Peppery Splash is definitely very on
Peppery is just
point.
Playing on a different level right now and it's just showcasing that. Holy. All right. Getting in there.
Ooh. And he's got those mid-range mix-ups. Swing or no swing.
Yeah. Those 6-H to give him some breather can, you know, get him out of the corner maybe, but then he has to think of the next situation. Like, what do you get afterwards? And then...
We're on the verge of a 6-0.
We are indeed. All right.
Oh.
Burst out.
Yeah, burst out.
Level 3 immediately.
All
far.
Right. Gets, okay. gets a 2P, but that's it.
Blitz reading yeah. the, assuming, misfinder.
Okay. Yeah.
Tries to go for the overhead there without any meter. That's why he catches the backdash. Okay, gets
just
out.
A little bit.
Give some breather.
But Peppery, of course, not pressured by that whatsoever.
Lots of like button presses here from T-Pots. He doesn't know. He's definitely not comfortable right now. Whereas Peppery right now,
he's already planning on what he's gonna do with the money.
Yeah.
Basically.
Jeez. All right. Okay.
Oh, good. Able to put that out before he gets air thrown.
All right. Gets in. Dust is plus 6-H. Not counter hit, so not much. Oh, wow.
All right. He has a chance to get it happening. Yeah, he just desperately trying to OTG him.
Throw.
And that'll do it, assuming that the burst doesn't come through. Blocks it on the other side, and Peppery
and
Splash takes it.
Like,
oh,
hey.
Yeah. Now you're doing something.
Oh,
yeah.
Double dash into throw.
All right.
Oh.
Yeah, honestly, that drop was very unfortunate because now he's playing the.
That's his IAD.
Yeah. And you see combo drop resulting in the other person in the corner.
Oh, no.
This is the worst possible way to go.
Okay.
Treasure hunt. Steal those question marks.
Misses, but still in there.
Oh,
nice back dash.
He's finding ways to deal with it now. So,
yeah. So one on each.
One each. There was a time when Peppery dropped his combo, SA teched out, had him in a corner situation, dropped his combo, and then Peppery teched out, got him in the corner situation. So, I can't say that SA necessarily played too poorly there, but the drop was catastrophic for him.
It's definitely a. Minimal mistakes allowed.
Damn.
Knockdown. Not blocking those lows.
Oh, 6P clash.
Wow, that caught the hover.
All right, so wow. 2 slash air to air. Gets this pretty good.
Ooh. It's gonna hurt.
Yeah, he's done.
Yeah, he's not gonna even take the just combo it out. It's okay.
He's still nowhere near burst. This is.
Oh, that was fast. All right, match point for Peppery. All right.
Oh no.
Oh man, those
that
two.
That was his chance to escape.
Those two is really working out for Peppery. Even catching some of the really low hovers. Go burst. All right. Lots of resources here for Peppery. Blocking those.
Yeah, he's been dealing with the jump dust.
I think
past two games.
Maybe he's realizing it's more of a comfort thing from SA. Like, he definitely likes doing those jump D a lot.
Uh-oh.
All right. Mid-screen conversion. We got those.
Nice.
Still in the corner, it's Y. Nope. 2S. That's it. Oh,
yeah.
Okay. All right. Got it.
I don't want to count him out, but it's not looking. Yeah.
There you have it. Peppery Splash taking it 2-1. Yeah. It's just that game. It's just turn based sometimes, you know?
Yeah. Peppery Splash. And if there was one adjustment I'd have to say that counted the most, it was just dealing with the jump dust, man. When SA got started, Peppery was able to backdash. You know, in some situations of RA.
Yep.
Just and even blocking it, honestly.
It's crazy.
Oh.
We got winner's finals next.
This is a classic.
We got winner's finals next.
This is a classic.
Is it? To be honest, I haven't seen T-Pox in winner's finals ever.
Oh, I don't mean like them being in winner's finals. I just mean like back in the ANC days.
Oh,
these
yeah.
These guys faced the tournament so much.
Right. ANC. RIP ANC.
Rest in peace.
Ah, gets right. Tagged. There it is.
Nice. Instant overheads.
This might be it.
Yeah.
There it is.
Good stuff from Ryan Ken.
All right. That was still winner's side, though.
Still winner's side, so we definitely see more of Lofo.
Yep.
And, as well as Ryan Ken. Woo. So, Dozonsen definitely clutched up for Ryan Ken there. He got good mileage out of it both times he decided to use it.
Oh, yeah.
There was only one time where he did it without meter, and in that situation, Lofo was still able to scrap him afterwards, but
yeah.
Other than that, still good. All right. So, coming up next, we have T-Pots versus Psychotic, which I think is actually a very good match.
Yeah. T-Pots come here from going through quite a gauntlet himself as well, and then...
And also, he's just been an up-and-coming player over the past, like, year and a half or so.
Oh, yeah,
2 years.
Sure.
Definitely since the beginning of Sign. Used to play Kai, switched to Coom. I know he tried a bit of Milia, but definitely going Coom here.
Yeah, I remember Toryuken last year. He was, like, switching between, like, Kai, Axel, like, something like that. And then Revelator came out, and the Coom DLC came out. And then since then, he's been putting in the lab works, man. Like,
oh, yeah, for sure.
So it really shows. And of course, Psychotic. If you guys are familiar with the Toronto, any of the Toronto tournaments, you've probably seen him once or twice. You know?
Yeah, definitely. And honestly, Psychotic's been to plenty of US majors. I'm sure if you've been to a major event in the last 2-3 years, you've definitely at least seen him.
Yeah, in both Guilty Gear and especially in Blaze Blue.
Especially in Blaze Blue.
He won Blaze Blue yesterday. So, and today, obviously, he's still ripping in Guilty Gear, winner's side, top 8. So, Coom versus Sim, both quite the high damage character.
Yeah, I think Coom's going to be the one working in the neutral here.
Yeah.
All right, they shake hands.
Yep. All right. All right. So we got those
transformation
scenes.
Tuner.
All right. Both got the green color going. It's a little different color from what you Sakai usually use, but it's okay. First offense from Sakai.
All right. Instant blocking those is going to be important.
All right. Gets cornered, but, oh, interesting. Sakata backs off.
Yeah, I think he was wary of the way that T-Pox was just kind of waiting there.
Yeah.
He spent his burst, but honestly...
He really wanted that win. Like,
yeah. No, I'm perfectly okay with that.
No burst, though. He bite.
Oh!
Chases
yeah,
him down!
Chases him down, indeed. Here we go.
Nice, how about it? All right. Oh, okay. Oh, no! That was a little scary there. That 6H nice. Was definitely accidental. Tried to go for a throw and accidentally got the 6H. A little risky stuff.
Elk trades. Just ends up bursting. Doesn't want to deal with that. Nice. We'll convert it.
Close to all the
right,
corner.
Psychotic. Yeah.
Woohoo!
That was a very risky bar, but he had to do something. I don't think he wanted to take that.
Oh, air.
Oh! The dust. Still unable to convert, but honestly.
6P.
Counter hit. Hayabusa will
that
take
do it.
Yep.
Yep. And there you go. Teapots 2-1.
Telling you, man. Teapots is looking strong right now.
Strong. Like, oh, man. That Coom. Good. Like, he's converting well. He's assessing the neutral well. Right now. It's like, I don't think Psychotic made mistakes or anything.
No, not really.
Just, that during that match, Teapots had the upper advantage.
All right. So next we got Bram Combo versus Peppery Splash. This one should be interesting.
Yeah, Bram Combo from Windsor.
Windsor.
Apparently, though, he is the only part of Windsor community for like a year, I believe, because he's originally from like the Middle East, I've heard, when I was talking to him
right.
yesterday. Yeah, cool guy.
And very solid player as well.
Oh, yeah. In pools, he beat Roldy.
And Posh P to make it out, I believe.
Yep.
So
he beat me as well. Yeah, he beat Roldy, then me to get into the top 16. And then
played Posh P.
Yeah.
So this one will be Raven versus Johnny.
Raven versus Johnny.
Interesting matchup, for sure. Peppery Splash, very explosive player. He likes to get into your mid-range and force you to make like decisions. Because he's just going to keep pressuring you. He does play both Johnny and Zato, but...
Yeah, he used to be a Slayer player.
Yeah,
and then
you could tell he was tired of that life.
Yeah.
Went straight to the the good old stuff.
The good old stuff, yeah. I don't know if he would... he's not scared to go into Zato if he has to, but... I guess he's going to stick with Johnny, which is fine.
Between the two, I do like his Johnny more. They're both, he actually just put time into both of them, but.
All right.
You know.
Bunt checks?
Bunt checks.
Yeah, hype bunt checks. Oh, my God. All right.
But this is another matchup that I'm interested to see as I've never seen it before.
Yeah,
so.
And also this is Revelator 2 Raven.
Revelator 2.
Can't move around as much as other characters will, but. In exchange, he just controls space so much better than a lot of the cast.
Of course. And they even gave Johnny, you know, different stuff to deal with projectile game to stuff his ground movement in this version of the game, so.
Yeah.
All right, full conversion from Peppery Splash. This is a scary situation for sure.
Do I? Oh, it doesn't even hit him. Yeah, that is a nerf that he Johnny got from Rev.
Fortunate. Oh, just Hayabusa out of there.
Alright.
Yeah, he's gonna convert that.
A little too much on the run.
Right.
First that. Yeah, that could have potentially led to death. So. Coom damage is no jokes. Backdash is out. Okay. The read on the Blitz is not bad, but he needs to realize that. He needs to realize that he likes those 2S and 2Ds. Oh, there we go.
All right. It's 1-1. Teapot's getting it started a little bit here.
Yeah. I feel like...
Ooh.
Okay. Coin starter. It skills a lot, so... Black beat. And... Oh, double
hit
too. Yeah, so it's not going to give him the hard knockdown he wants. But he still has level 2, I believe. There it is. Okay. Whiff punishes the air Hayabusa. Misses. PRCs to make it safe. Now he's in the corner.
Oh.
Fireball just goes away.
Maybe try to trick him that he was going to throw there. But Teapot's still on the offensive here.
Yeah. Oh, God. Uh-oh. Level 2 misfires through the fireball. Steals that lipstick.
The lipstick, yeah.
Yep.
Yeah, I think he even... Wait a little bit there to maybe try and catch the burst.
Now it's just
there
you
was
can't burst.
Yeah, just there's not. And it's funny because he's even waiting to try and block at the start of that.
Yeah.
You know.
First blood goes to Peppery Splash.
Already on the path to trying to reset this. I don't know. I'm pretty sure we're gonna see a reset. Maybe not. But Pepper
Let's
Splash
see how much adjustment T-Boss can
exactly.
make.
Exactly.
Right now...
It's really hard to say after the first game, of course.
Yeah,
yeah, it just runs up. Different...
Ooh, wow. Oh, no.
And that's what I'm saying. Even though that was a weird situation, Pepper Splash still managed to make it a good look.
All right. You're in this corner still. Okay.
Interesting.
Interesting indeed.
I want to say that was an error, but I'm not sure.
Couple of nerfs showing from both players, perhaps? Oh, wow. Fireball just went away. Oh, no.
Nice whip punish on that. That was pretty far away.
I think that might...
Many different names he entered as,
of course.
Now that he's... Now that he's sponsored, I think he'll be sticking with...
Sponsored by TTT. But, yeah... Today's been like one heck of a day. Yesterday too, to be honest. Like lots of Guilty Gear action. The pool matches were crazy. Teams were crazy. And now this top eight, like people at home, I hope you guys have been enjoying this because I know I have been.
I've been enjoying it as well. Teams was awesome. Of course, the competition yesterday was great. And now here we have, and honestly, I don't think anybody had teapots on their fantasy bracket for Winner's Side Grand Finals.
I don't think I saw either.
But like I said, so T-Pots came to, like, we had a Guilty Gear DJ at my house on Friday, and he bodied us so hard. And honestly, after that, I was definitely thinking that, like, you at least make top four, so.
And now, here we are, Grand Finals, T-Pots winner side, and Peppery Splash loser side. This has got me one hell of a match. So, I don't think they fought each other in this tournament at all, actually.
Yeah.
So,
I know they've clashed at Red Bull.
They have?
Maybe off stream, but I know, man, I know they've clashed at Red Bull.
Peppery does have quite a bit of the aura ahead of him if he wants to take all
this. He's
got
the character to do it, though.
He does.
He's got that damage. He's got those mix-ups. The pressure game. Peppery's, and the fact that he just blocks every burst.
Yeah. Yeah.
I think players, when you face Peppery Splash, just try and scheme your burst a little bit harder than right when you get hit by a big starter because he's watching.
He's watching. He's really good on picking up on those people's like tendencies.
Alright, we're getting started here. These two taking their time in the neutral, just trying to counterfeit each other.
Ori corner here. Nice use of FDA. I actually like that. Uses resources, obviously, but it's not bad. Oh, wow. Can't get out. Still gets the knockdown situation. Burst out. All right. Okay. 6-H.
6-H, yes. And then he... A
bit
late.
Oh, no. Yeah, too far.
Oh,
trying
nice.
To back that out. Lots of stare down from here.
Peppery Splash is able to convert regardless of the situation. Some of his buttons, you know, hitting in weird situations, but he's still able to either convert into a combo or a good air throw situation. So, T-Pots is going to have to.
T-Pots really has to find a comfortable range that he wants to be in, but that's really hard because obviously Johnny as a character has so much, covers so much of the screen, right?
He can hit you for big damage at that range.
Yeah. Like, technically, if Johnny. Johnny with that dash that he has can't move around as much as other characters will, but in exchange, he just...
Adjustments.
Yeah.
For sure. And already, good backdash.
Yep. It's in.
Challenges it this time. Oh, man.
Oh.
That would have been a very tricky conversion to get. So he just opts for the tech chase.
Yep, you're in this corner this time. All right. SA, you gonna hold on to that burst.
Two side
pressure. Oh, okay.
Oh, whiffing all sorts of stuff.
Yeah, TK Cycle Crusher, or what I'm gonna call it. Oh, I gotta wake up.
Oh,
level 3 miss.
Just
fire.
Wanted to finish him off with it, but it's.
All right.
Oh,
yeah. Catches him.
Oh,
no.
Oh,
the dust.
Yeah, just not enough to kill somehow. Oh,
yeah.
But he gave him a little bit of a stare down before he let it rip.
Yeah. It's like,
Now you're doing something. Oh, yeah.
Double dash into throw.
All right.
Oh.
Yeah, honestly, that drop was very unfortunate because now he's playing the.
That's his IAD.
Yeah. And you see combo drops resulting in the other person in the corner.
Oh, no.
This is the worst possible way to go.
Okay.
Mm-mm-mm. Treasure hunt. steal those question marks.
Misses, but still in there.
Oh,
nice back dash.
He's finding ways to deal with it now. So,
yeah. So one on each.
One each. There was a time when Peppery dropped his combo, SA teched out, had him in a corner situation, dropped his combo, and then Peppery teched out, got him in the corner situation. So I can't say that SA necessarily played too poorly there, but the drop was catastrophic for him.
It's definitely minimal mistakes allowed.
Damn.
Knockdown? Not blocking those lows.
Oh, 6P clash.
Wow, that caught the hover.
All right, so two slash air to air gets us pretty good.
Ooh. It's gonna hurt.
Yeah, he's done. He's done. He's done.
He's not gonna even take the just combo it out. It's okay.
And he's still nowhere near burst. This is.
Oh, that was fast. All right, match point for Peppery. All right.
Oh no.
Those
that
two
was his chance to escape.
Those two is really working out for Peppery, even catching some of the really low hovers. Go burst. All right, lots of resources here for Peppery. Blocking those.
Yeah, he's been dealing with the jump dust.
I think
past two games.
Maybe he's realizing it's more of a comfort thing from SA. Like he definitely likes doing those jump D a lot.
Uh oh.
All right, mid screen conversion. We got those.
Nice.
Still in the corner, it's why? Nope. 2S, that's it. Oh,
yeah.
Okay,
all right.
Yeah, got it.
I don't want to count him out, but it's not looking. It, 2 punch, not early enough. Like
oh,
you said,
there it is.
Coom's weight playing a big factor here in the conversion.
Wow.
Oh. Yeah, good conversion. Needed to go into that, but.
Okay.
Combo game.
Oh, no. Wasn't blocking the overhead from the second hit.
Yeah.
Even with Hellfire, still not going to kill.
Yeah.
I don't know if that even added any damage. Oh, punches her. Like, nah. Wow.
Shanking
that was
him.
That was the low, too.
Yeah.
So
you had to call it out.
That was a pure rock, paper, scissors right there from both players.
Yeah. And it's good that T-Pots is not letting him get away with that. Yeah,
there
not,
you go.
Letting, not letting him get away with it.
Yeah. Here it is. Conversion. One more. Ooh. Okay.
And that,
still good damage.
Yeah. Oh, still able to get the conversion, and that's another thing. T-Pots. Very good conversion game for Coom.
Yeah. The delayed overhead. Yeah, because of the super flash, pretty sure you can't Azami that. Probably the best answer Coom has against Azami.
Alright. Gun. Shoots him with the gun.
Yep. Gun. Them cannons.
The good air to air challenge there.
Yeah, block.
Oh, yeah, stuff the run in with the jump slash spacing.
Oh, gets caught.
And my T-Pot's having consistent answers for Suzeran.
Yeah. At least he's searching now. Oh, catches him. Tummy gosh. Oh, that's gonna combo. Yep. Catches him low. Chase down. Trying to lots of guns from Ryan Ken. I don't know what he's trying to achieve with that, to be honest. Like, it does go under the Coom fireball, but like, oh god, 2P. Oh!
Here we go. I'm not sure if he has anything special prepared
for
that.
Yeah, that's not gonna convert well. Danger time. Yeah,
he's not trying to hold two mortal counters there.
Oh! Oh! Okay, dead angle's out.
Gets caught trying to do something other than block.
Still not gonna kill.
Oh. Oh my god. This is scary. Yeah.
6-8!
It was good. It was good. He saw the 2 slash. He knew this guy's going to do delay to Tommy. I'm going to instant block it and immediately make him regret that decision.
That's 6-8 though. 2-0 so far for T-Pots. 6-8 again! Grandpa Viper.
Yeah, no, he's not trying to mess with that.
Nah.
All right. Ryan Kent trying to find his way out of the corner.
Suzuran's out. Alright, keeps some corner pressure going with the YRC. Okay.
Nice. Unable to get anything off that.
Nice. Oh!
Man, he has some very good spacing with the ball there.
Yeah.
Oh,
here
everybody's
it comes.
Favorite. Oh, that's getting punished with mortal counter.
Oh, no.
Alright. So.
This is gonna hurt.
I don't think he's dead, but he's
not
bleeding.
Dead, but.
Oh, he tried to RTL it. He wanted to RTL there. That's a psychotic special to clutch it out with a wall rising HS and RTL.
Is there extinct?
Yeah, oh, look, no. That was a startup of his super, right?
Yeah.
Oh, he's plus one?
Yes.
Oh, psychotic still with burst. Might choose to do it on block.
Okay, a little too far there.
Burst wow, RTL. And that's just going to take it.
All right.
Had to spend his burst, but honestly.
He really wanted that win. Like,
yeah. No, I'm perfectly okay with that.
No burst, though. He might. Oh, chases
yeah,
him down.
Chases him down, indeed. Here we go.
Nice, how about it? All right. Oh, okay. Oh, no. That was a little scary there. That 6H nice. Was definitely accidental. Trying to go for a throw and accidentally got the 6H. A little risky stuff.
Elk trades. Just ends up bursting. Doesn't want to deal with that. Nice.
He can convert
it.
Close to the corner.
All right, psychotic. Yeah.
Woohoo.
That was a very risky bar, but he had to do something. I don't think he wanted to take that.
Oh, air air.
Oh, the dust. Still unable to convert, but honestly.
6P.
That should do it.
And there you go. T-Pots 2-1.
Telling you, man. T-Pots is looking strong right now.
Strong. Like, oh, man. That Coom. Good. Like, he's converting well. He's assessing the neutral well. Right now. Just like, I don't think Psychotic made mistakes or anything.
No, oh, not really.
Just that during that match, T-Pots had the upper advantage.
All right. So next we got Bram Combo versus Peppery Splash. This one should be interesting.
Yeah, Bram Combo from Windsor.
Windsor.
Apparently, though, he is the only part of Windsor community for like a year, I believe, because he's originally from like the Middle East, I've heard, when I was talking to him yesterday. Yeah, cool guy. And
very solid player as well.
Oh, yeah. In pools, he beat Roldy.
And Posh P to make it out, I believe.
Yep.
So.
He beat me as well. Yeah, he beat Roldy, then me to get into the top 16. And then
played Posh P.
Yeah.
So this one will be Raven versus Johnny.
Raven versus Johnny.
Interesting matchup, for sure. Peppery Splash, very explosive player. He likes to get into your mid-range and force you to make like decisions. Because he's just going to keep pressuring you. He does play both Johnny and Zato, but...
Yeah, he used to be a Slayer player.
Yeah.
And then...
You can tell he was tired of that life.
Yeah.
Went straight to win a lot of sets that would have been a lot less stressful had he... Oh, there we go.
Yeah, I'm okay.
He's thinking about it.
he definitely thought about it.
K2's jam is good, but...
Yeah.
It's just, throughout the day, I've seen him go down and have to win the set with Mei, like, at a disadvantage, so... It's
maybe,
just good to hear he's starting off
maybe
with...
Maybe in, like, a final situation, 3 out of 5, maybe a little bit more safer to do that, but, like... The thing is, like, I don't know what Jam offers that Mei doesn't, aside from speed. Like, damage Mei has them. And, like, set play, obviously, Mei's is better, right?
Yeah.
So, like, I'm very curious to know what K2's philosophy on, like, the choice of Jam over Mei. So.
It could just be that he's interested in the character, of course.
Of course, yeah.
Something you have to ask him, I guess.
Yeah.
Okay, but he's not playing around. He knows SA.
Yeah, he
knows.
He knows.
All right, gets hit by the low note, but SA unable to fully convert.
Cool. So as a main player, he definitely wants to... he's going to be in the air a lot because her jump normals are crazy good. But
and that jump arc as well. All right, burst.
But Eno does have a lot of answers against airborne characters, so... And then, of course, gets the pressure going right here. Lots of neutrals with projectiles, nodes, and otters. SeaWorld versus... some sound festival.
Yeah. And you can see that K2 hasn't really gotten a chance to get started.
Yeah. This is roll SA right now.
Alright.
Yeah.
Oh, throws him into the node as well. So I noticed that K2 is favoring the otter in the neutral. But it is still very early in set, but yeah, that's what I'm saying. I guess it's just to cover more airspace.
It is a good move. Oh, yeah, that was going to lead to damage and set plates.
Ooh. Scary. Yeah, K2 just backs off. SA is on full offense right now.
But obviously, Eno does have the horizontal advantage, which is obviously horizontal chemical love.
Oh, man. Good box from K2 here.
Good blitz. Recovers in time, though.
Yeah. Ooh, Otter YRC.
Oh, catching that dash.
Nice, just hits him low.
Just escapes with the dive kick, or the dive.
All right, jumps off the beach ball.
My God, what am I watching?
It's like a demonstration at SeaWorld.
Oh,
nice. Hits him one side, ends on the other.
Ah, the ball just wasn't there to hit it, but...
Funny, K2 hasn't really converted the full damage yet, but he's just getting his hits in and playing slow, which is honestly, I think, a perfectly acceptable game plan right now.
Yeah, both of these...
Ooh.
Both of these characters can be quite rushed down if they want to, but no.
That burst from Essay was an interesting choice.
I feel like...
Yeah, fortunate, but still gets a good amount of damage.
It is Sin, after all. All right.
There we go. Nice, maybe try to catch the up back with a 6P there.
Nice DP. He was definitely going for a run-up throw right there. Oh. All right.
Oh, up back HS.
A little bit of stare down right there. Corner pressure. Right, ooh,
yeah,
I got this burst.
Burst.
Well, he has to burst, I suppose. Poke, poke.
All right.
Oh, nice. The Grand Viper.
The Grand Viper. Oh, that was weird.
Oh.
All right. This is still very scary for Psychotic.
Yeah, that angle's out. Man for Psychotic. Yep, that is how it works.
All right, that camera pan is doing some funny stuff this time around.
Yeah.
All right, a little bit less pressure because both these guys are in winners, but of course, they both want to advance, ideally.
Ideally, yeah.
All right. Oh, that's going to be a whip punish. And a very good whip punish at that.
Yeah, he doesn't bother for loops. Doesn't matter. Still damage.
Yeah, I was on the lookout for that air high boost there, but it was smart for him to YRC it.
Okay.
Just barely.
Yeah, you have to be really careful about Sin's wake up beast. One of the slowest in the game by far. Oh, let it swim. How much can he get off this? Pretty chunky damage.
Interesting air ender. I respect it.
Yeah, still a hard knockdown. Burst out. Nice air throw.
Ooh.
There it is. Wait. I mean, loops.
Yeah, should get him here.
Yeah. Good damage. Wow.
And this is a match point for T-Pots here, so Psychotic gonna have to play a little bit more conservative. Or who knows, maybe he should rush it down, but either way.
There is a Yep, gets the conversion.
That's a funny conversion. Right. Knew he was going to fade back with the dust there.
Yeah.
So wakes up confidently.
Oh, here
everybody's
it comes.
Favorite. Oh, that's getting punished with Mortal Counter.
Oh, no.
All right. So.
This is going to hurt.
I don't think he's dead, but he's
not
bleeding.
He's dead, but.
He tried to RTL. He wanted to RTL there. That's a Psychotic special to clutch it out with a Wall Rising HS and RTL.
Is there anything?
Yeah, that was a startup of his super, right?
Yeah.
Oh,
he's plus
one?
Yes.
Oh, Psychotic still with Burst. Might choose to do it on block.
Okay, a little too far there.
Burst RTL. And that's just going to take it.
All right.
Had to spend his Burst, but honestly.
He really wanted that win. Like,
yeah. No, I'm perfectly okay with that.
No Burst, though. He might. Chases him down.
Yeah, chases him down, indeed. Here we go.
Nice, how about it? All right. Oh, okay. Oh no! That was. Alright. Gets in there. Nice blitz.
Oh, no.
Gets a level 2.
Oh, and that's very worth it for SA, if I do say so myself.
Yeah.
That jump. Dust. Here we go. He's gonna get to hit him with that note. And the note whiffs, unfortunately, and he's able to get up a trade.
Mm-hmm. But still advantage for SA.
Oh!
Just a little too far. Alright, gets hit by the coin anyway.
Nice! He whiffed the jump 2K, but still. Just whiffed the 2K, able to still convert.
It's that fast.
Yeah. That was. Oh, man.
Alright. 2S from SA this time. 2H, yeah.
Try to maybe hit his throw West there.
He's
getting some big hits with that. Speak of big hits.
Being hit, yep. This round apparently is a Johnny's turn.
Oh yeah.
It's a turn-based game, apparently.
Johnny, still his turn.
Unable
to finish, but not a whole lot SA can do in this situation.
Yeah. Let it rip with that level 3.
Oh, but SA's... Oh,
back dash RC.
Oh! SA just wants to maybe it's contested at least.
Yeah, I don't know. That I got this burst.
SA has a tendency to burst on low HP. He does definitely have the character to get something started afterwards, but he just... Yeah.
I don't know.
You gotta wonder. All right.
Wow.
All right. They'll both take that.
Gets in. Yep. Whip punishes. Burst
good
out.
That he burst him on the other side.
Oh! That try jump. The literal try jump. All right. Is this round SA's turn? There's a jump deep. No burst. This is going to do a lot of damage. He can't hit with the super. Yeah. Oh, doesn't even need it.
Doesn't
good damage.
It.
First match of SA. So all in right. teams, we did see that SA did have at least a first one advantage over Peppery. We see again, first to one, so far SA has an advantage.
It's up to Peppery to make those adjustments.
Yeah.
For sure. And already, good backdash.
Yep. It's in.
Challenges it this time. Oh man, that would have been a very tricky conversion to get. So he just opts for the tech chase.
Yep, you're in this corner this time. All right. SA gonna hold on to that burst.
Two side
pressure.
Oh, whiffing all sorts of stuff.
Yeah, TK Cycle Crusher, or what I'm gonna call it. Oh, I got wake up.
Oh,
level
no.
three miss.
Just
fire.
Wanted to finish him off with it, but it's.
All right.
Oh, uh oh.
Oh, yeah. Catches him. Oh, no.
Oh,
take it with us.
Yeah, just not enough to kill somehow. Oh,
yeah.
But he gave him a little bit of a stick.
Catch you. Okay. Lots of 2S here from Peppery. Trying to probably catch a Beak Driver. Well, you gotta play careful.
Just wants to keep at least half of his life.
Blocks the.
Nice! Baits him in with that eat. YRCs. Alright, 6P still able to block.
Stuff the approach there with 2S.
Oh, great defense from Peppery right now.
Good mix of defense right there. But then gets tanked out while trying to escape.
He just wasn't able to get started. And that's what it comes down to.
That's how it is.
Psychotic has the burst, which means he's able to make a mistake.
Or he's going to do the wake up RTL. Burst RTL. Ooh, okay. All the way to the corner?
Yeah.
Yo, coast to coast?
Nice.
Right, close
unable to finish it, but you know.
Yeah. I don't know if that damage was worth it for 4 coins that he has spent, but we'll see.
Ooh. A little bit of fast-paced spacing from Peppery's Bosh coming out.
Yeah. So far, Psychotic is definitely getting the advantage with the damage output here.
That was a very good backdash.
Mm.
Oh, all right. This is a chance to get started. Never mind.
Yeah. Not capitalizing on those like hits he's getting. There
okay,
we go.
Just go for the treasure hunt. And
all right. Is this the starter?
Ow.
Yep, this is going hard.
Ow.
All right. Yeah,
you brought it up before.
Yeah.
Oh, man, he actually did it.
Yeah.
Oh!
Oh!
That was sick. All right.
Okay,
nice.
Okay.
That was a cute little conversion from Peppery Splash. Closed it out there, and Psychotic nowhere near burst, so he's got to bring the fight to Peppery Splash.
Yeah.
Oh, man, he was trying to get a 6K at Whip Punish that, maybe.
Beak Driver doesn't care.
Yeah, Beak Driver never cared. Yeah.
Yep.
There you go. Exactly. Oh. All right. Gets the coin, gets the 6K, and he will take him all the way where he needs to be in the corner.
Level 3. Watch out.
Got to watch it. Oh, bam. Yeah, that hurts.
Ends with the level 3. Overhead.
Oh,
yeah,
nice.
Nice.
You know, every time someone stands that, I'm so happy for them.
Yeah.
Because that's a life or death situation. Right.
Yeah. Peppery does like ending the round with that, too. So.
All right. Nice.
Gets knocked down again.
It's going to be a tough one. Oh, just jumps off.
Tries to air throw. Oh. All
right, Psychotic got all the meter he needs to go crazy. Yeah, it doesn't even have to wire see that.
All right. Level 1 misfinder for Peppery Splash right now. Yeah. Still playing with it though. Still doing it. No coins left, but air throws in. During that match, T-Bots had the upper advantage.
Alright, so next we got Bram Combo versus Peppery Splash. This one should be interesting.
Yeah, Bram Combo from Windsor.
Windsor.
Apparently, though, he is the only part of Windsor community for like a year, I believe, because he's originally from like the Middle East, I've heard, when I was talking to him yesterday. Yeah. Cool guy.
And very solid player as well.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, he in pools, he beat Roldy.
And Posh B to make it out, I believe.
Yep.
So.
He beat me as well. Yeah, he beat Roldy, then me to get into the top 16. And then
played Posh P.
Yeah.
So this one will be Raven versus Johnny.
Raven versus Johnny.
Interesting matchup, for sure. Peppery Splash, very explosive player. He likes to get into your mid-range and force you to make, like, decisions. Because he's just going to keep pressuring you and pressuring you. He does play both Johnny and Zato, but...
Yeah, he used to be a Slayer player.
Yeah.
And then...
You can tell he was tired of that life.
Yeah.
Went straight to the... The good old stuff.
The good old stuff. Yeah. I don't know if he would... he's not scared to go into Zato if he has to, but... Yeah, I guess he's going to stick with Johnny, which is fine.
Between the two, I do like his Johnny more. They're both... he actually just put time into both of them, but...
All right.
You know.
Butt checks?
Butt checks.
Yeah, hype butt checks. Oh, my God. All right.
But this is another matchup that I'm interested to see, as I've never seen it before.
Yeah,
so.
And also this is Revelator 2 Raven.
Revelator 2 Raven.
Got some quite beefy buffs for him.
Yeah, I honestly... in the first version of Raven, I thought it was a little bit disappointing that his excitement meter was like barely a thing.
Yeah.
And now, that's like he's basically a resource character now.
Yeah.
Once you get that high excitement, you got big payoff.
He gets it from obviously command grabs now, and
the rate at which it increases when he armors as well.
Yep.
Is buffed. So.
Yeah. So and then Bram combo, at least against myself and a couple other people, his use of like excitement stance into YRC to check people was really good. So we'll see how this goes. Oh, and immediately starts off with it.
And you see just one move, and he's already in there with the excitement.
Yep.
All right, we'll see what he goes. Good backdash. Recognized that the ball wasn't quite on top of him.
Yeah. All right, already cornered here, but...
This is what I'm saying. Peppery Splash likes to get up in your face and play that mid-range game to make you... Ooh.
Yeah. Gotta watch out for the 2H. Like, even if Johnny goes in, you gotta be worried. Like... Even if you want to throw him, that 2H will get you. If it counter hits, you're Dunzo.
And Dunzo is a very good word to describe the amount of damage that Peppery Splash will be pumping out here. If he lands a clean hit, definitely something to be wary of.
Yeah. All right, one piece each. Going to the final match here.
All right.
RS. Okay.
All right, nice.
Ryan came with their approach.
Oh, sorry, Lofo attempted to throw there, and Ryan can double jump.
So. Oh, heck, jump S. He throws again, yep. Yeah,
Oh, nice.
Questionable burst there from Lofo.
Definitely, but also good awareness from Ryan Ken.
Is this going to be enough?
He did double jump confirm. I like that because I'm pretty sure he would have had a hard time knocking down in that situation.
Right.
Which is why... That or he just wanted the extra damage, but either way, Ryan can.
Yeah, it worked out for him.
All right. Bit late on the 6P there, but...
So hard to...
anti-air heavy stun edge.
Yeah. Kai usually as a character is really good with anti-airs, and then he definitely... Ooh, 6K to avoid that. But yeah, sometimes he wants to anti-air Viking, but it's so scary because he has those tatami pressures as well, which will neutralize the 6Bs and such. Gotta respect those.
Nice.
Stun edge, all right.
Could use stun edge to cover the horizontal distance on the ground.
Not bad damage on that Yohazunsen combo. Gets right. Tagged. There it is.
Nice. Instant overheads.
This might be it.
Yeah.
There it is.
Good stuff from Ryan Ken.
All right. That was still winner's side, though.
Still winner's side, so we'll definitely see more of Lofo.
Yep.
And, as well as Ryan Ken. Yep. So, Yohazunsen definitely clutched up for Ryan Ken there. He got good mileage out of it both times he decided to use it.
Oh, yeah.
There was only one time where he did it without meter, and in that situation, Lofo was still able to scrap him afterwards. But other than that, still good. All right. So, coming up next, we have T-Pots versus Psychotic, which... I think it's actually going to be a very good match.
Yeah. G-Bot's come here from going through quite a gauntlet himself as well, and then.
And also, he's just been an up and coming player over the past like year and a half or so.
Oh yeah,
2 years.
Sure.
Definitely since the beginning of Sign. Used to play Kai, switched to Coom. I know he tried a bit of Milia, but definitely going Coom here.
Yeah, I remember Toriyuken last year. He was like switching between like Kai, Axel, like something like that. And then Revelator came out, and the Coom DLC came out. And then since then, he's been putting in the lab works, man. Like,
oh yeah, for sure.
So it really shows. And of course, Psychotic. If you guys are familiar with the Toronto, any of the Toronto tournaments, you've probably seen him once or twice. You know?
Yeah, definitely. And honestly, Psychotic's been to plenty of U.S. majors. I'm sure if you've been.
We'll see.
Oh, nice. All right. I like how that had a sound effect for a little pose there. Oh, yeah. And that's what I'm saying. He just gives SA the benefit of the doubt. He knows.
Nice backdash.
Backdash into jump, and man.
These dolphin pressures. Oh, the dust!
Did he get hit jumping?
No, if he got hit, well, maybe. The damage! Oh my god!
Oh my god! Oh!
I don't think that's gonna hit.
I don't think so either.
Yeah.
Yeah, but it recovers so fast, able to throw him still.
Nice 6B!
Alright. SA's. Yeah.
Oh no!
Oh no!
6B!
6B!
Oh god!
Clash is not the ideal situation for May there.
Nice!
We'll just let this one speak for itself.
2K. Okay.
Yeah, 2K. Whoa, I didn't know she was like doing like a B-boy thing.
The
there.
B-boy thing? Yeah, low profile B-boy. Alright.
Alright. Yeah, both of them just choose to give each other the space. He's in there with the stroke of victory, but still a scramble.
Yeah. Ook!
Ooh, hits him on the way down. Like I said, he doesn't even need full combos. He can just get those hits. But just as I say that, converts into a bad combo.
Yeah.
Oh, you're not blocking that.
No one's blocking that. All right. We get it. Ooh. Oh!
A lot of air tech situations for K2.
Yeah, air tech into otter, too. That was weird. Maybe he wanted to.
Oh, block the helicopter arms.
Ah, just not enough meter.
And a quick turnaround from SA.
Quick 1-1. Yeah. That reversal could have helped if he had 100 meter, but didn't get
time. Kind of smiling, they know. Like, that was a little nutty. The scramble situations. It's a little hard to tell what's going to happen. Who's at advantage early? But
I think May has an advantage of mid screen because.
All right.
Now this situation.
Oh, good otter covering up the jump out. Yeah, nice. Punishes that on the way down.
Nice 5P end here.
And converting to massive damage. SA.
Ooh!
Nice. Unable to punish.
But still a failed burst nonetheless.
Ooh. Yeah, he's backing up. He doesn't want. Oh, K2 with the pressure. That was honestly a very good approach with the beach ball covering it.
Oh god, jump S. Okay, otters. Wow, using RRC to get the approach. Right. Trying to check in with the JK right there.
Oh, the projectiles clash a bit there off screen.
Oh!
Beach ball. Oh!
The go burst. All right, what are you going to do with the resources? Trying to go for the air throw?
He's going
to
go buck. That's what he's going to do.
Uh-oh. I don't know about that, VCL. You use all that meter that you just had. All
right, good beach ball to get rid of that note.
Yeah.
Yeah, just hop over that one. Hop over that one as well.
Goes for Lofo too, though. He pretty much almost has it back. Yep. A little damage there, puts him to the corner, pack dashes away, but then back just into the corner.
Low profile's the vapor thrust. Hits him out of the tech.
Yep. I think that's an OS as well. Oh, there it is. The ref 2 changes for Eno.
Alright, yeah. Didn't exactly get a lot of mileage out of that burst. He's gonna get the Oki here.
He's blocking. Ooh,
nice.
Alright. Is this a start?
Okay. Oh, all right. I like that.
Alright, put her in the grinder. Oh man. Under the far S right there. Okay, can't make any more mistakes. Wow,
ooh,
jump
above
H.
Above and behind, jump H coming through.
That guitar. Yeah. So that command grab, it's not technically a command grab anymore for Eno. It's a proximity unblockable, just like a
Faust.
Or Pot's. Or I guess Faust too, but Pot's. Heat knuckle. So that's the reason you can combo into it now, which is good for combo extension. The only quote-unquote nerf for it is that you can blitz it now, technically. Yeah. But, you know. But it's only the ground one. So if you do the air one is still a command grab. So that's the reason why SA can still do those option selects to catch burst, catch text, and such. All right. So that was a quick first game. Let's see if Lofo can make some adjustments here.
Get air there.
Yeah. That's the first hit. Oh, doesn't block the dust. Immediately burst out, yeah. Doesn't want to give SA the turn that he wants. There it is
nice.
With the
getting
air
getting a lot
air
of mileage out of
jump
air there. Yep.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, there
nice.
It is again. Good damage. Yep.
Oh.
Beefy damage. Oh, no.
Nice. He's, you can see him cranking those fuzzies.
Yep.
All right, all right.
Even on life, more or less. Oh, wow. Again with the jump K.
Yeah, that sucks because Lofo finally had a chance to get started. Mm. Here we
There's
go.
There's a new 6H. Okay,
oh,
drops
yeah,
the combo.
Just a bit.
It's in. Jump D. All
good
right,
good.
Block.
He needed
yeah.
to block that.
Oh. Yeah. Lofo's not getting hit by too much of those because I think he knows that SA loves doing those jump D.
Good tech forward from SA regardless.
Oh! Yeah. Little misinput there from SA.
He wants to take the round.
Ah,
yeah.
Yep. All right.
And SA ahead by quite a bit.
Oh, wow. There it is. There's a try jump right there. That is pretty dirty.
Yeah. Now.
Oh. Catches the back dash. tries to go for the side switch, but had the right idea, but
right,
jump
the two of them
again.
Fighting to keep the and also in the neutral as well. He's waiting for the Suzeran to come out. He's waiting for the Azami. And then even if he sees him holding Azami, he'll still threaten him by trying to maybe hit the startup of his follow-ups and
yep.
whatnot. So.
The follow-ups are really fast, though, so you got to be very careful with you.
Yeah, definitely.
Because sometimes I try to like try to go in with a jump cancelable normal, right? Which
yeah.
is most, and then try to chicken block the follow up.
Yeah, and it still gets you in jump start.
Yeah, and I'm like, yeah. oh, okay. It's pretty brutal.
Lofo. Definitely something to be wary of.
Yeah. All right, one piece of each. Going to the final match here.
All right.
RS. Okay.
All right, nice.
Ryan came with their approach.
Oh! Sorry, Lofo attempted to throw there, and Ryan can double jump. So.
Oh, tech jump S. He throws again, yep. Yeah.
Oh, nice!
Questionable burst there from Lofo.
Definitely. But also, good awareness from Ryan Ken.
Is this going to
yeah.
be enough?
He did double jump confirm. I like that because I'm pretty sure he would have had a hard time knocking down in that situation.
Right.
Which is why. That or he just wanted the extra damage, but either way, Ryan can.
Yeah, it worked out for him.
All right. Bit late on the 6P there, but.
So hard to.
Anti-air heavy stun edge.
Yeah. Kai usually as a character is really good with anti-airs, and then he definitely. Ooh, 6K to avoid that. But yeah, sometimes he wants to anti-air Viking, but it's so hard, scary because he has those tatami pressures as well, which will neutralize the 6Bs and such. Gotta respect those.
Nice.
Stun Edge, all right.
Could use Stun Edge to cover the horizontal distance on the ground.
Not bad damage on that Yoh Zunsen combo. Gets
right.
tagged. There it is.
Nice. Instant overheads.
This might be it.
Yeah.
There it is.
Good stuff from Ryan Ken.
All right. That was still winner's side, though.
Still winner's side, so we'll definitely see more of Lofo.
Yep.
And, as well as Ryan Ken.
Whew.
So, Yoh Zunsen definitely clutched up for Ryan Ken there. He got good mileage out of it both times he decided to use it.
Oh, yeah.
There was only one time where he did it without meter, and in that situation, Lofo was still able to scrap him afterwards. But
yeah.
other than that, still good. All right. So, coming up next, we have T-Pots versus Psychotic, which I think is actually a very good match.
Yeah. T-Pots come here from going through quite a gauntlet himself as well. And
yeah.
then.
And also, he's just been an up and coming player over the past like year and a half or so.
Oh, yeah,
2 years.
Sure.
Definitely since the beginning, it's definitely.
Wow,
but honestly, Psychotic was pretty close to losing that convincingly. The fact that he was able to bring it back is, you know, able to maintain some of his momentum going into the second match here.
Oh, yeah. Sorry, off for 6P. Oh, there it is.
Big counter hit, yeah.
The first out. Doesn't want any of that. There, right. Elk to go under the fireball. Yeah. Yeah.
Nice. Just yeah. Stares him down.
Just wait. It's all good.
Uh-oh.
All right.
Yeah.
Let's calm down a little.
Nice. Just charges him down back by the fireball.
Okay.
All right. Low on food is psychotic, so he's got to
chase
space.
Down that pack dash. All right.
Oh. All right. He's got to eat now.
Yeah. Usually, Kuhn will have to respect those, like, let him eat it, but...
Ooh.
But he's okay with that.
All right.
Fireball.
A little bit of a cross-up there.
Yep.
Oh, input error. Perhaps he wanted super? I don't think he wanted that on wake up.
There's a 2B mash.
Ooh.
Good use of FD right there. All right, here comes a big ball.
And now it's Kuhn's turn.
Yeah, the Kuhn ball.
Ooh, yeah.
That was actually really smart just at the end too, because that fireball, even if Kuhn gets hit, it stays.
Oh man.
Nice. Okay.
Little bit of a weight on there.
He didn't have a blitz back, so I would have not charged that probably.
Yeah. Maybe he was a bit wary of sending him full screen. Ow.
Oh. Still works out, but sending him a message.
Nice conversion.
Nice.
All right.
Yeah. There's a high. All right.
Teapot's in firm control of the match right now. Psychotic with no meter. All right, let's burst out right away.
Alexander does. Ooh, interesting. TK peak driver.
All right. Chases him down in the air. Doesn't want to give him the space for the Hayabusa.
Gets the food. Giving them clap.
Oh, clap.
Woohoo. Yeah. Trying to beat it.
Nice. Good spacing from Teapots.
It's plus. Good blocks.
Oh, that was so weird.
Oh! Oh, nice. Nice. Hayabusa. Oh, wow. Did that beat 6P? I swear he got 6P out. Oh, jeez.
That looked really weird. Okay. And now. Yeah, just backs up.
Doesn't really want to overcommit. Oh!
Alright, Psychotic being a little bit more wary of their Hayabusa this time around.
Yeah.
Oh, Elk.
Since 6P is still a problem, so. Gets right. Poked!
Oh, unfortunate. But still gets a good amount of damage.
It is Sin, after all. Alright.
There we go. Nice, maybe try to catch the back with the 6P there.
Nice DP. He was definitely going for a run up throw right there. Oh? Alright.
Ooh.
Good use of FD right there. Alright, here comes the big ball.
And now it's Kuhn's turn.
Yeah, the Kuhn ball.
Ooh!
Yeah. That was actually really smart just at the end too, because that fireball, even if Kuhn gets hit, it stays.
Ooh. Oh man.
Nice. Okay.
Little bit of a weight on there.
He didn't have a blitz back, so I would have not charged that probably.
Yeah. Maybe he was a bit wary of sending him full screen. Ow.
Oh! Still works out, but sending him a message.
Nice conversion.
Nice.
All right.
Yeah. There's a high. All right.
Teapot's in firm control of the match right now. Psychotic with no meter. All right, let's burst out right away.
Alexander does. Ooh, interesting. TK peak driver.
All right. Chases him down in the air. Doesn't want to give him the space for the Hayabusa.
Gets the food. Giving them clap.
Oh, clap.
Woohoo. Yeah. Trying to beat it.
Nice. Good spacing from Teapots.
It's plus. Good blocks.
Oh, that was so weird.
Oh! Oh, nice. Hayabusa. Oh, wow. Did that beat 6P? I swear he got 6P out. Oh, jeez.
That looked really weird. Okay. And now. Yeah, just backs up.
Doesn't really want to overcommit. Oh!
Alright, Psychotic being a little bit more wary of their Hayabusa this time around.
Yeah.
Oh, Elk.
Since 6P is still a problem, so. Gets right. Poked!
Oh, unfortunate. But still gets a good amount of damage.
It is Sin, after all. Alright.
There we go. Nice, maybe try to catch the back with a 6P there.
Nice DP. He was definitely going for a run up throw right there. Oh? Alright.
Oh, up back HS.
A little bit of stare down right there. Corner pressure. Right, ooh, yeah, no, I got this burst. Well, he has to burst, I suppose. Poke, poke.
All right.
Oh, nice. The Grand Viper.
The Grand Viper.
Oh.
Oh, that was weird. Oh. All right. This is very. Yeah, this is still very scary for Psychotic.
Yeah, that angle's out. Me in for Psychotic. Yep, that is how it works.
All right, that camera pan is doing some funny stuff this time around.
he keeps like, yeah.
All right, a little bit less pressure because both of you guys are in winners, but of course, they both want to advance, ideally.
Ideally, yeah.
All right. Oh, that's going to be a whip punish. And a very good whip punish at that.
Yeah, he doesn't bother for loops. Doesn't matter. Still damage.
Yeah, I was on the lookout for that air high boost there, but it was smart for him to YRC it. I'm unable to convert, but...
Nice use of YRC there to make his approach really unpredictable.
Ooh, good slide. Gets a little bit of a Hail Mary. Had meter to back it up, though.
A little bit of damage here. Kun can take those, though. The overhead.
All right, he's trying to just
jumping
get that hit
of
in. A lot of jump back Hayabusa.
Sakai definitely wants that air throw, but dang, backs off now. Super,
and
all
that's
right.
Going to be his turn. Ooh.
Yeah, he really wanted that food. He wanted his food to be, like, safe.
Ooh! Oh my, that's unfortunate. Psychotic.
That
the composure to
see.
Hang in there. Just play it nice and slow.
Little too overambitious with those air Hayabusa kicks.
Definitely. And just as they say that, just go for it anyway.
It's still a good move.
Oh, here we go.
Real good damage. A little too far.
Still though. Forced to respect the ball.
Yeah.
And now, a little bit of a scramble situation.
Same with the slow wake-up speed.
Oh. All right. That was definitely a weird little scrap.
Bit of damage here.
Man.
This time he gets punished.
Yeah.
Overhead.
2P into jump dust.
All right. Still anyone's game.
All right, yeah.
Just jumping out too much. Oh.
Will he? Yeah, I think he should be able to end this. Yeah. You know what? It looked to me like he actually tried to bait that.
Yeah. RTL?
Oh.
Yeah. Okay.
Nice.
I was a little scared about if he could punish, but good choice there with the Hayabusa.
Definitely. But honestly, Psychotic was pretty close to losing that convincingly. The fact that he was able to... bring it back is, you know, able to maintain some of his momentum going into the second match here.
Oh, yeah. Sorry, off his 6P. Oh, there it is.
Big counter hit, yeah.
And burst out. Doesn't want any of that. There. Right. Elk to go under the fireball. Yeah.
Nice. Just stares him down.
Just wait. It's all good. All right.
Yeah.
Let's calm down a little.
Nice. Just charges him down back by the fireball.
Okay.
All right. Low on food is Psychotic, so he's got to
chase
space.
Down that pack dash. All right.
Oh. All right. He's got to eat now.
Yeah. Usually Kun will have to respect those, like let him eat it, but.
Oh.
But he's okay with that.
All right. It's a little bit of a cross up there.
Yep.
Oh, input error. Perhaps he wanted super. I don't think he wanted that on wake up.
There's a 2P mash.
Ooh.
Good use of FD right there. All right, here comes a big ball.
And now it's Coom's turn.
Yeah, the Coom ball.
Ooh!
Yeah. That was actually really smart just at the end too, because that fireball, even if Coom gets hit. Uh-oh.
Nice. Just charges it down back by the fireball.
Okay.
All right. Low on food is Psychotic, so he's got to
chase
space.
Down that pack dash. All right.
Oh. All right. He's got to eat now.
Yeah. Usually Coom will have to respect those, like let him eat it, but.
Ooh.
But he's okay with that.
All right. It's a little bit of a cross up there.
Yep.
Oh, input error. Perhaps he wanted super? I don't think he wanted that on wake up.
There's a 2P mash.
Ooh.
Good use of FD right there. All right, here comes a big ball.
And now it's Coom's turn.
Yeah, the Coom ball.
Ooh. Yeah.
That was actually really smart just at the end too, because that fireball, even if Coom gets hit, it stays.
Ooh. Oh man.
Nice. Okay.
Little bit of a weight on there.
He didn't have a blitz back, so I would have not charged that probably.
Yeah. Maybe he was a bit wary of sending him full screen. Ow.
Oh! It still works out, but sending him a message.
Nice conversion.
Nice.
All right.
Yeah. There's a high. All right.
Teapot's in firm control of the match right now. Psychotic with no meter. All right, let's burst out right away.
Alexander does. Ooh, interesting. TK peak diver.
All right. Chases him down in the air. Doesn't want to give him the space for the Hayabusa.
Gets the food. Giving them clap. Giving them clap.
Oh, clap.
Yeah. Trying to beat it.
Nice. Good spacing from Teapots.
It's plus. Good blocks.
Oh, that was so weird.
Oh, oh nice. No, Hayabusa. Oh, wow. That beat 6P? I swear he got 6P out. Oh, jeez.
That looked really weird. Okay. And now. Yeah, just backs up.
Doesn't really want to overcommit. Oh!
All right, Psychotic being a little bit more wary of their Hayabusa this time around.
Yeah.
Oh, so, out.
Since 6P is still a problem, so. Gets right. poked!
Oh, unfortunate. But still gets a good amount of damage.
It is Sin, after all. Alright.
There we go. Nice. Maybe try to catch the up back with a 6P there.
Nice DP. He was definitely going for a run-up throw right there. Oh. All right.
Oh, up back HS.
A little bit of stare down right there. Corner pressure. Right, ooh, yeah. I got this burst. Well, he has to burst, I suppose. Poke, poke.
All right.
Oh, nice. The Grand Viper.
The Grand Viper.
Oh.
Oh, that was weird. Oh. All right. This is still very scary for Psychotic.
Yeah, that angle's out. Mirror for Psychotic.
Yep,
that is how it works.
Oh, there's up and start here. Yeah. Oh.
Ooh,
nice. Just throws him out of the 6K. All
right. Black beat. He'll take it, though.
Yeah, just
runs under again. All right. It's going to be damage. Misses it. Okay.
Yeah, just backs up. Gets hit by Tsunami, but able to get the air throw out.
All right, nice. There you go.
Yeah, wouldn't have been at the range to convert there.
Okay.
All right,
convert that.
He's got to get into a super. Oh, more slash, either way.
Whichever works. All right, still staying alive.
He's hanging in there.
Yeah. Still a burst for Peppery Splash.
Yeah, it's funny. Oh, you're going to crouch under it, eh?
But let me trip you there. All right.
All right.
In the corner. Backdashes this 2H.
Wow, recognizing the gap or maybe the misspacing, but
yeah.
Man.
Ooh, Suzuki into the dash again. Okay. Horror scenes? Guards out. Wow, air Azami. Okay.
Nice. Those low Azamis are coming pretty clutch. I guess, nice behind him there.
There you go. Okay. Yeah, a little more use out of those dash follow ups after Suzura. But it's just gonna. That's gonna whiff.
Yeah, it's gonna whiff. And I'm not sure if he has the damage closed out here, but that will definitely do it.
There you have
it. Peppery Splash taking a 3-0.
3-0.
Very, very strong. Showing Peppery Splash.
But still, third place from Ryan Ken using Baiken.
Using Baiken. And that's what you got to take away from this. Baiken, very, very new. And people haven't really figured out how to get knockdowns off of everything, what's finite, what's not, you know. And you can see he's even playing around the fact that he doesn't necessarily have that knowledge. He's waiting for the text. He knows too high up the combo. Well, that was pretty good, honestly.
Maybe he needs a new name, Ryan Baiken.
Yeah, Ryan Baiken. Nah, man. He'll be forever be the Ryan Ken. I know he had, like, a bunch of funny different names he entered as,
but
now that he's sponsored, I think he'll be sticking with.
Sponsored by TTT. But, yeah. Today's been, like, one heck of a day. Yesterday, too, to be honest. Like, lots of Guilty Gear action. The pool matches were crazy. Teams were crazy. And now this top eight, like... People at home, I hope you guys have been enjoying this because I know I have been.
I've been enjoying it as well. Teams was awesome. Of course, the competition yesterday was great. And now here we have, and honestly, I don't think anybody had Teapots on their fantasy bracket for winner's side grand finals.
I don't think